The pipes are called.
If I die, you better fucking rip it at my funeral.
I'll sing with passion. I'll give it my heart.
I'm gonna shoot a cap gun in the air 21 times.
21 cap salute. Vecchione will just lay a pot of spaghetti at my, my casket. It's noodles day. Remember when we used to cheat? Remember cheat day?
I didn't have enough time to do calzone.
Every day. Dude, Vecchione, when we lived together, I'd be like, you know, I always eat like shit. So I'd be like, on Sunday, when I get pizza and all this stuff? And he'd be like, I've been saving up for 2 weeks for this. I really would like that.
I'd like a slice of pizza.
Yeah. Like, you know I'm going to pour Reese's Pieces on this Talenti, right? You know I'm going after
it. Like, I'm aware. I'll be zen in my room.
The way that Vecchione was so responsible with his diet, watching me eat must have been like, this fucking animal.
I don't know why this hasn't hit me before at all, but we should do a 1 month... wife swap of let Will Witzke live in Jacob's place, and then Jacob just moves in with Lou.
The show will break up. There's no way Jacob can. I think Will would be fine in Jacob's apartment.
I'm just saying give Will a place to stay.
Oh, I know. But I'm saying the thought of... I just immediately thought of Lou lighting up a cigarette inside.
It would be a double murder.
Can you guys do... Can you do this? Can you
kill
do
each other at the same time?
Listen, it doesn't have to be this moon tower, although it would be great if it was.
Could
you guys share a room?
What? No.
I want to hear the stories of you guys just observing each other for a couple days.
I would want to take it on the high seas and have them share a room on a cruise.
Cruise ship? Wow, dude. We're going to be in a fucking Dateline NBC episode.
Yeah, being interviewed.
For sure.
Yeah, where it shows
hell
old pictures
on the
of
high
us.
Waters.
Yeah, man. One of you guys getting tossed over, the other one disappearing.
You guys wouldn't spend like a week together in a place.
I don't know. I just think my general smell is a turnoff to Jacob. Like, opposite.
By the way, how good of a person Jacob is, it took everything in him there to not just wholly agree with you when you said, my smell offends him, and Jacob went,
it was like watching
he's got to give me like, he's right.
Can I say it?
You don't mind if I say it to you?
I'm going to say it.
I mean, Lou would despise me for the same reasons I would despise him.
No,
we can't get along.
The opposite reasons.
No, I think it'd be...
The opposite reasons.
Yeah, you would... You would be upset with the smells and the smoking. The smells and the smoking and the smoking.
Zipping and the bopping. How about the place where you can't smoke inside?
No, it's not happening, Jay.
Yeah, but the smells I bring in from outside.
Please.
I mean, I'll do it. Give my brother a nice vacation. He'll love your place.
Yeah. And then you can constantly bring your girlfriend over to pork while Jacob listens.
the thought of Jacob and Lou having
I love the idea so much.
Before bed talks.
It's such a great idea.
He's like, Lou, what are you thinking about?
Cigarettes. What are you thinking about?
That's a great...
Joey Logano.
This is a great American dad when Stan and Snot go to sleep in the same room. He goes, do you think people are having sex right now? He's like, yeah. How many? He goes, yeah. Tons, probably like 80.
I would love those, Jacob and Lou. We should do those as a special download.
Black Lou, is this not a phenomenal idea?
It's absolutely the greatest idea I've ever heard.
It's the greatest idea that you guys spend.
We'll put up Zoom. We'll put up Ring doorbells and then please. Audios.
Like, yeah, let's Big Brother you guys for just big, 4 days.
I would. By the way, we can do it at a hotel.
Yes.
We'll do it at a hotel
You'll
in the
do
city.
It?
What's that?
You'll do 3-4 days.
he's the yeah. producer, and him wants to say yes, but he wants to say no. It's one of these things where he's like,
Black Lou. Unobjectively, this is a fantastic idea.
Yes, all I can picture in my head is Will taking a selfie video in Jacob's apartment, like, hey, it's me. I'm ready to go. Jacob's apartment, night one. Oh, just the excitement around it.
He's like, he's got this awesome Nazi book.
Yeah.
I'm going to look into this first.
Some interesting stuff I got planned after reading that.
Yeah. It'd be great if you came back and there was just an imprint of Will on your couch.
But definitely, we don't have to send Will to Jacob's.
We can get him a hotel room.
For 4 days.
We can get him a hotel room. You know,
or a nice Airbnb, and
yeah,
then,
we can. And we'll pay. Jay and I will pay for the Airbnb.
Yeah,
and then you guys will.
I don't know what Jacob's doing. It's puzzling me.
He's attacking me with eye contact.
Is that what he was doing to me before? He's like nodding and looking with his eyes wide open.
He's on some Florida Gator shit, and he's like trying to walk me down. I'm telling you
right now. Back down, Gator?
He's going like this. He's going like this.
Back down, Gator?
He's just going...
I'm listening. I'm taking it all in.
No, you're not.
There's no chance of this in any way.
Lou, we can get there. Jacob.
Lou's already there.
That's a great idea. Also, I think the world should get off fossil fuels. I think if we do that too. Can we do that next week?
Well, yeah, you'll be using less fossil fuel because you'll be in the same place.
It's also a much greener solution. Jay's got a point.
You guys are going green.
Let's end world famine.
Yeah, but that's...
We can't do that. We can't do that.
We don't got Bezos money.
It's a great idea.
No, but we can't do it. This is an achievable idea. It's a terrible analogy.
What we can... Yeah, you're right. Because what is affordable is us getting you a fucking 2-queen room down at the Hilton and slapping some fucking Ring doorbells around there. Some good audio. Yes, Jason?
It's a good toe dip into the thing. I'd like full time together, but I think a fair thing would be Moon Tower because there's going to be a times when like one of you is going to have to take a dump and one's got to take a shower. Like the crossover is going to be just fantastic.
He's trying to walk you down. Don't let him do it.
You're not going to kill my confidence in how great this of an idea this is.
Yeah.
It's a fantastic idea. And you are wigging out because you know it's a fantastic idea.
I tell you, it's cracking through.
It's a week of shows. Easy.
Oh, my God. The recap?
The Lou and Jacob tapes?
You guys odd coupling would be
Black
huge.
Lou.
If Lou took a dump in my hotel room
because
we're sharing.
It's both your hotel
rooms.
Right. It's
so when
your...
he came out, he would find me hanging from a noose.
No, don't over-exaggerate.
First off, finding a pipe that strong, having rope on you.
You're planning on too much going on with this hotel.
No, you'd have to have all the pieces.
These hotels are new constructions. They're not holding that up.
I'm pretty sure that thing ain't union. You're going right through that drywall. Hilton, yes. Marriott, no way.
Yeah, don't be crazy.
And Lou, it's not your duties, anyone's. No, I'm not putting this on you.
Lou,
they're trying to make a thing now.
Do you think how you would be annoyed by like day three?
Forget DJ Lou. Here's what DJ Lou's going to get through it because what's going to be the funniest is when he drills home after being lost with God knows who at 3 a.m. and collapses into the room drunk on Jacob, who's like, you know, wearing a picture of a nightcap.
Yeah.
And like
some sort of apparatus.
And he's just like sleeping like a little. Like a little baby angel.
Portable humidifier next to his face.
And DJ Lou goes, you don't mind if I eat this bag of Sun Chips?
He sits down and he goes, Rumi, gotta talk to you. You ever met Charles from Seattle? He's a camper. I like him.
Charles, no, I'll describe him. Red shirt.
Garden salsa. Dude, I'd love it.
It's killing Jacob. How good of it. Black Lou's begging for it.
Yeah, Black Lou, come on, guys. Can we put it to a vote?
And Black Lou will, like, you know, he'll be responsible for, like, getting you guys, like, captured and what's going on with all this. Yeah, all right, Jacob's nodding yes.
Jacob said yes.
So that's on record.
DJ Lou?
Yeah.
I just asked that Lou be able to smoke inside.
Well, we can't do that. It's a hotel.
It's a hotel.
Ah, okay.
And we don't want to subjugate
Jay. I'm going to put Jay through
for,
that.
You know, we don't want to give him.
First of all, you don't know how I cut loose in a hotel. You don't know me.
The way you
described me is, I don't even know that person.
Sorry, dude. When you
always
put
in there
with the baby oil and the condoms
and the dehumidifier.
No, I'm just saying. I think you're not going to be psyched as I would be.
Shane Gillis in the hotel room, no clothes.
What'd you say?
You go no clothes
because it's just me.
Yeah. Well, it's going to be
you and Lou.
So maybe
you
something.
Still choose I mean, to go I'm not no clothes. Do
that. Maybe some Euro cuts.
By the way, Lou's girlfriend. Is coming to the
even
venue.
Better now. Mm-hmm. This idea is really coming around. This is getting good now.
Three.
So now you're sharing a room with Luminous girlfriend.
Boot camp.
You're really getting the full Will experience.
Yeah. This is fantasy Will camp.
Are you playing VR Will?
You go in. By the way, we got to up you to about a pack a day.
We'll start VR whiskey.
Yeah. Bring him in, dude. You can sub in as his twin.
Oh man. Yeah, you guys got to exchange lives or live together for a little bit. One of those two things has to happen.
Yeah.
You can use your own voice, Jacob. I won't change your voice.
No, you want my answer?
You're going to say no.
I'm saying no.
Jeez.
No.
All right.
I'll be honest with you. You really let down on this. Black Lou.
Yeah.
But Black Lou. Look at, damn it.
He knows you guys as coworkers. You guys are friends.
He knew the answer, too.
Black but Lou. His producer brain knew the correct answer.
Sure. Mine did, too. If, I went Black against Lou, it. I fought my producer brain.
If Black Lou didn't have a family he had to take care of, he would do an immersive weekend with DJ Lou and see how the Witsky boys live. I bet that's absolutely a dark documentary.
I'll tell you what, I would come off the wagon for that immersive experience.
Oh my god.
I would be smoking butts. I would sleep right next to
every ashtray is also wet.
I love it. I would love just to watch the news and smoke cigarettes
with the Witsky boys.
Would kill for it.
Eating handfuls of fucking corn pops out of the box.
No, just have a nice cold one and a cigarette.
By the way, Lou, just, you know, I don't think these are the real things of your life. I just always think it's funny to design. That's what I don't want to explain that before you get mad. I don't think you wear a nightcap, or I don't think you're a nerd. I don't think Jacob's a nerd either.
I'm fine with it all.
Okay, then wear a nightcap so Jacob thinks it's cool.
You two living together, maybe we don't do it at Moon Tower. Maybe we just, you know, do a week of it. Yeah. We'll just do a week together near
work. It's a reality show. You guys are a set reality show.
Listen, we can get some funding from the bonfiremerch.com. The bonfiremerch.com.
All right, Big Jim.
Big Jim.
I know Buns Basketball seems to have fallen through. I haven't heard anything back about it. And there was another big lofty plan I figured out we also threw at him.
Well, Jimbo, I don't know how Big Jim dropped cheeks that big. Yeah. But it looks like, I think there's still a chance. People are tagging us that Buns and Basketball wants to come to NYC. They just don't have a promoter.
I know. And Big Jim doesn't think a name sounds good on a flyer. Big Jim presents.
Big Jim's Butts and Baskets.
Jim, please.
Come
let
on.
Let us call this thing Big Jim Presents.
We'll even let you wheel out your hot sauce that you're trying to soft launch. Come on, dude.
Big Jim's Fiery Garlic.
He's got an aioli that's going to kick your dick in, and he's going to premiere it at Big Jim's Buns and Baskets.
Come to Big Jim Presents Buns and Basketball.
It's not Buns and Basketball. It's Buns and Baskets, because we have to change the name, you know, trademark-wise.
No. He's presenting their product.
I don't know. I heard he had investors. I heard there were angel investors.
But there's
investors.
Also like a smoked ribs burn-off outside.
Dallas Barbecue's co-sponsoring.
Please, and I'm going to get you one of those bolo ties, but the tie ones. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like strings.
Yeah.
Like
dude.
Colonel Sanders.
Dude, and Big Jim only speaks in third person. Oh, Big Jim's real proud of his bonfire boys.
Big Jim likes his seats here for the buns and the bag of balls.
I'll tell you what, they tear those tailwears off. I see those big buns.
All right, Big Jim, we might need you to call into the show. We need you. We're holding firm. This is our negotiations.
Yeah.
You have to give us one of these three things.
Buns
you
or basketball.
You have to. We're asking for three things. You can't give us one of them?
Come on.
We want.
This is like when you have a sleepover and you go to your mom and you're like, pizza or movie or both. Come on.
We want buns and basketball to happen. What was our other thing? What was the thing we asked for the other day? Me and Lou couldn't think of it outside. What did we drop buns and basketball for?
Oh, we traded something in for it.
However,
due to the amount of marijuana we smoke, I cannot remember.
It's not that. Marijuana is probably what brings it back.
No. That's what I'd like to believe, but hey, I don't.
Jacob,
think that's
your
truth.
Sober notes aren't helping. Real nice, dude.
Hey, your cop notes don't work.
Just the facts.
Quan Mills, something with Quan Mills.
What is it with Quan Mills to get? Oh, it was for us.
Well,
the readings or something.
While we think of it, Black Lou.
Wait, the third thing though. I'm laying my demands down. The big gym.
Sorry, third thing.
Third thing is that these aren't demands. These are requests. Don't call them demands when you yell back at me. I know you're the boss. But listen up, motherfucker. Buns and Basketball, something with Quan Mills that we'll recall at some
and
point.
A pizza party.
Or
a Lou and Jacob sleepover.
You have to get behind a project, produce a project where we get some sort of a cabin house and just in the we'll take it to your neck of the woods, Jacob, where we can go. We'll be wilderness.
We'll go out.
But you and Lou in the wilderness for a week. Just 1 week. You could teach him how to fish. He could teach you how to fucking light a cigarette off another cigarette.
Yeah. He could teach you how to siphon gas. You could teach him how to build a nest. Look at all these things.
No nightcaps.
Yeah.
No gowns. Just two guys roughing it out in the woods. Come on.
Dude, come on, Jacob. You're teaching him how to hunt.
The only thing is, the one thing that's a... It's a must for me.
Yeah.
And I hate to micromanage this.
Throw it out there. Ideas are bad ideas.
I need you guys sharing a sleeping space. You can't have your own respective rooms to go to. No,
you got to be in the same four walls for slumber, recharge. Jacob, I'm not going to lie, and I don't want to be this guy, and we've never had this relationship on the air. I'm going to put my foot down and say that's going to be a have to.
Well, have to. This is all provided Big Jim comes down.
We get the funding from Big Jim's bail bonds.
Which I think is possible. So at this point, Jacob, if I were you, I'd be lobbying hard to get Bunsen basketball to town or something involving Quan Mills.
Yeah, I would go for the first two options because if not, we're bearing down on third.
Because that's one. Because I'm going to tell you, doable.
Third is the most, I think now we're seeing it, third is the most possible
option. I'm starting to think about maybe Big Jim throws the axe at this one, then I'll say maybe me and Dan just produce this. So self-produce this.
You think I haven't been squirreling away that billions money?
There's money to be made.
I know how we talk on this show. I've been saving my money.
There's money to be made in the Jacob DJ Lou
roommate biz.
Roommate, but for sure.
Jay, I'm going to say that there is room for biz, and biz is a booming.
Biz is booming, and let me tell you this:
we're filming it.
Yeah, dude. We're going to document it. It's like our Jersey Shore.
Yeah.
Like, you guys, every once in a while, we just send you on a vacay together, but you got to do things together. Jacob, stop. You're nodding. I'm taking it as a yes.
He's doing it again.
Jim, make him. Big Jim. I'm calling you, Big Jim. Bring the hammer down.
Dear Big Jim, up on 37, please make Jacob live in the woods.
Jacob's looking to get fired. Jacob wants to get fired and go back to Florida. He's over it.
He's looking for a severance package so we can go fucking feed the gators.
Go back to Florida. I'll send Lou with you. I think I won't send Lou with you.
Do it, Jim. Force me. See what happens.
Big Jim. Show some respect. Jim.
Yeah, dude. Grande Jim.
Second idea. You get to go to your happy place, a room in your mom's house for some reason. That's not my...
the doll room at the Bataan residence.
Put things into perspective.
For some odd reason, a room in your mother's house.
Your safe space. So what's bad? That?
But we send Lou to stay with Jacob and his parents.
I mean, that's... Lou, how do you feel about that?
I don't think we'll last 2 hours, but I'll try it.
You don't have a choice because you're being paid by Big Jim and Buns and basketball money.
It's not fair to me because... I respect Lou's lifestyle, but he could put up with me, my lifestyle. It doesn't affect him as much as mine.
Oh, dude, all your routines. I don't think I could sit through all your fucking things you got to do to get through a day.
What's this show's already taken off, man.
What's my routine? You don't know my routine.
Hey, guys, I'm going to need you to stop the pitch meeting real quick because we're getting too many buyers.
So all the things you clean and wipe down and all the personal things.
Please, clean sheets. Who wants that? So gross.
I'm not helping you. I'm going to help you stain them.
Damn, fuck this.
Yeah, guys, all this and more.
God, I love this.
Next week on a very special Jacob and Lou roughing it.
Oh my God, dude, out in the
making
woods.
Making fun of me for having a clean. You don't even know how I clean. What do you clean?
I know how you clean.
I remember when you said that you and your brother hired somebody to clean your apartment like it was a fucking monumental thing. When was the last time she was here? Then.
It's called a deep cleaning, motherfucker.
Yeah, when was the last deep cleaning?
When was the last time?
I'd say we're due for one. Thank you.
Now, Lou.
I can't say the date because it was the last time he said it on the air.
Now, Lou, do me a favor, Lou. Now break away and just look at your camera and just do a confessional like you're upset about what Jacob's been, the way he's been treating you in the house.
Yeah.
If you could please.
Jacob's really getting to me today. How many times are you going to wash your fucking hands?
I'll do the producer. I'll be the producer, too. He goes, what's the problem? He's
having
exactly with
you. Wash as many times I want.
Jacob, I'm going to need you over here to talk to me.
Sorry,
a bit.
Jacob.
I'm in a booth, Jacob.
He's in the booth. He's in the confessional booth.
Yeah, let him.
Jacob, you want a confessional booth? You feel like you want a confessional booth?
No,
go ahead.
Just right over here.
Your camera, please.
Lose up.
Jacob, I'll be producing your interview. Just give them a second.
Go ahead, Lou. Sorry.
Okay, I'm going to feed some things. What could Jacob do different in the way he approaches you about your stank-ass sheets?
Yes, I know I'm not as clean as him, but he doesn't have to make me feel bad about it every day.
Oh, that's true. Do you wish you could make him feel bad?
Yeah, use his toothbrush.
Great. There's more alcohol.
Yeah, those are good cuts. Okay, can we have a producer's meeting real quick?
Yeah.
We got some stuff we can really make him look bad.
That's good.
Yeah. Jacob, hi for our interview.
Yeah.
What's going on? You doing all right?
I'm not doing well. I knew it was going to go down like this. I don't like... that he doesn't respect the way I need to live my life.
Yeah. Did it hurt the way he said that you clean in a weird way?
He criticizes me for being an adult. Just and I don't like it.
Okay, good. Now you guys start the war again.
No, we got to go like this. Jay, okay, are we having our water balloon fight? All right, let's let him out for the water balloon fight. I go, we are going to be busy in editing.
Producers, do you see on the call screen we have 10 grand thrown at the project?
No, by who?
By Big Jim?
By John from New York.
My God, all right, John from New York's in for 10 grand already, Jacob.
We got a buyer on the phone. And Big Jim, if I know Big Jim, he's going to be coming in with big sponsorship. He's going to be coming in with a lot, maybe Tesla.
But, oh, we probably get some. We probably get Tesla involved in this.
Oh, that piqued my interest.
See?
Oh, so there is.
Jacob, think about all the CW parties you're going to get invited to.
And listen, once this thing goes over, we work during the week. It can't be like this.
You don't mean
it'll be every weekend for like a month, and then we see how it goes, and then season two picks up.
I mean, if we get picked up, and if we do,
it will be picked up for sure. It's going to be a huge hit.
And then when, you know, and the inevitable season three, also known as Will's Revenge.
You guys know you
bring
are
Lou
the actual,
and Will.
You guys know you are the actual Odd Couple.
Yeah.
You're a guy who, like, you know, you sanitize your hand to touch your dick. And Lou doesn't give a fuck. He would let a
Jacob myth.
He would let a
Jay's on-air Jacob myth. Go
okay,
ahead.
Well,
sorry.
Well, Lou also wouldn't let a toothless hooker spit on his dick so he could jerk off with the lube either. But it was the funniest thing to say.
I was going
to
say eat fries out of the trash, but I like that better.
Okay, either one of those he wouldn't do. But it's just comedic effect, Jacob. You're very wound up now, and I get it. You're stressed. You're going to be spending a lot of time.
Because I already feel anxiety as if this has been happening already.
Big Jim. All right,
I can't even contemplating it gives me anxiety.
The way Jacob's turning on me, I'm leaning more towards wherever it is, DJ Lou smokes inside.
Yeah. I'm going to tell you right now, we're going to have to pay a cleaning fee because now I'm starting to lean it. Let him rip.
I'll pay it. Let it rip. Let him rip. Jacob, but you're going to be doing things that are going to affect Lou's health also.
Making tea.
Yeah. What do you want? You trying to get rid of that fucking throat coat he's got going? He's going to start coughing when he smokes again.
Yeah.
You knock that shit down with tea. Get out of here. What, you going to cast you?
I'm wondering if we would bond if I gave him a glass of tea, and we actually just bonded over it.
No, it's going to be the
nice
best.
Drink of tea.
No, you are.
Yeah. That's the
you
big
are gonna
moment.
Bond. You are going to bond, and then you're going to find out that he's like wearing your underwear because he forgot to pack underwear, and that's going to make you skits, dude. Dan, give him the interview about the underwear.
Okay, can I interview you real quick? What would you say if you found out Lou was wearing your underwear?
I consider that a personal, like a boundary that you don't cross. Like I tried to extend an olive branch to him, and I made us tea, and I thought it was going well. And then he basically steals my possessions and wears them.
This is good. Okay, all right. Now you take yours? Confessional.
Yeah. Okay, great.
Okay,
I'll be in the editing.
And I'll be leading. That's what's going to be good. Mm-hmm. We have to learn how to start getting them worked up.
Oh yeah, no, we need to find the beats.
DJ Lou, like, what's this? What's Jacob complaining about? Like, you something with his underwear? What's the big deal?
I don't even remember doing that.
But he's saying that you did. Dude. Do you feel bad about that at all?
No, I'm trying to find a steak. What do you guys eat down here?
Yeah,
what kind of meat? Can we have some kind of meat today?
I think we're at your... Oh, no, we're on a ranch somewhere.
But I'm going to tell you right now, the Team Lou, Team Jacob shirt's going to be flying off the rack.
But listen, also, Jacob, you get to do... Because it's a show, so you have to have some, like, spice put in there. You're going to get to do things you love, like outdoorsy shit that was going to be fun to watch Lou do. And then you've got to hang out with Lou... And watch, like, you know, I don't know,
so with
pornography
Dan,
on your phone.
So you're going to go hiking, and Lou's going to be out of breath, and he's going to want to stop, but you know what I mean?
That's the funny.
That's your thing.
And you show off your thing. And then later you do Lou stuff.
With 10 grand budget.
No, that's a buyer.
That's one producer.
That's one producer.
John from New York, I believe, is his professional
name.
Which
is, we might bill him as that, as producer. But, I mean, we got Big Jim coming in with the lion's share.
Mm.
You got Jay and
Big Jim, for sure, is coming in looking no less than six
figures. I heard
figures.
He's freeing
that's
up...
That's my guess.
Yeah, and I've heard he's freeing up liquidity out of other things. I heard he's taking a serious stock and selling it.
Yeah, this is going to be huge.
I mean, I heard he's moving stuff around to make this
happen.
I bet
Steven Singer's ready to jump all over this at ground level.
I heard that's why he came onto the show.
Yeah.
And if you think Bambi's back by mistake, think again. Large stake in this.
Yeah, who do you think's going to be HR for when one of us eventually gropes a PA?
Yeah.
Bambi's going to handle that. Guys, this is in-house. It's perfect. It's so perfect.
And you two are the stars.
And then every weekend, just for like almost like exhibit, like an intro and outro, Black Lou's going to come deliver you a box of food.
But it's
some
only
supplies.
But here's, we're trying to get it like a Blue Apron or someone, so the only food you can have on the weekend is cooked by you two together.
Jacob, if I don't see you and DJ Lou try to fucking build a tent together, I'll fucking kill myself. Yeah. I can't not see that now. The frustration of you guys trying to build an old poly tent.
And if you think I don't want to see a Hawaiian theme reunion show where you two show up to confront each other,
the fighting in Lays
at a luau, I'll spit blood. I'll be so mad.
Because also, you guys won't see your confessionals
till the show airs. I mean, that's the genius that we're
working
on.
That's the juice of the show.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, that's what the Bad Girls Club always. When they show up to the reunion,
yes,
then you're nice and flared up because now you heard all this shit. You thought by the end that you and Lucas, you're going to eventually do some sort of like, you know what? We learned a lot about each other.
Yeah.
Blah, blah, blah. We're better for it. And I love you. I think even though we know for sure we can't live together, what a fun, you know.
And then
we're closer than ever. And then you go home.
And you're going to see episode 5 where he says that you snore like a bitch.
Not even just that. You're going to see episode 5 when he sticks his toothbrush up his ass. You know what I mean? Like your toothbrush up his ass.
And then Lou's going to come in spicy realizing that you threw his cigarettes out half a pack.
And kept telling him you didn't know where they went. You had no idea. And you committed to that hard.
Lou, are you a snorer, Lou?
Is he a snorer? Don't answer that, Lou.
What?
Yes.
Yeah, what?
Lou, I'll handle that for you. Of course. What?
Hey, is Lou good at making fire randomly appear?
No,
yes.
In the same room.
He sleeps like
sleeping
a kitten.
In the same room.
Same room, yeah. That's the fun.
Yeah.
Jacob, you can sleep in those gun range headphones.
Yeah, dude. We'll make sure that you have some noise canceling.
I feel like you're going to have those jacked producers on set to break us up.
We're going to hire the Bad Girls Club producers.
Are you kidding me? I think you beating the shit out of Lou Witzke 4 or 5 different times would be the funniest thing ever on television.
Fucking pussy.
You smoked again.
Has Big Jim called in yet? Why is he? You think he's probably calling Hollywood?
I heard he's on the phone with Merrill Lynch. I heard he's on the phone with
mortgaging some shit.
I heard he's on the phone with some several big players.
DJ Lou is acting like he's not in, but he's so in. Black Lou couldn't be more. Black Lou's also giving $10,000.
I know, yes. Lou would hate this. Sorry, Lou. Go ahead.
I just wanted to say the other project that Big Jim was going to sponsor was us taking over the Quan Mills TV show.
Oh,
based on
right.
The books.
Right.
Sure. That might be too rich. That might be too rich.
Can I tell you something, Big Jim? You're looking at a lot of scratch there. We can get this thing done pretty cheap.
And I'm just gonna throw this out there. I would say let this be our proving ground. We do it with the Jacob and Lou show, take the money from that, go into business with Quan Mills.
Yes. What we do with our money after the Jacob and Lou show, but Big Jim, all we need right now,
Bonfire Productions will move to Quan Mills after.
We need Sirius XM. XL stations, of course.
What's that? That's
Big Jim?
Did he give you a number? Did
you guys are actually making headway because I just checked my phone and I got a text from Big Jim and it says, Big Jim presents the Jacob and Lou Airbnb live stream.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah,
that doesn't mean I'm committed. I'm saying you
that's
have,
all right. We can
you
get
have
you.
A backer.
Oh, Jacob, you're committed now.
Jacob,
Big Jim just said it.
It's called entrapment. We're just closing the doors around you. You don't realize that all your options are slowly being taken away.
Big Jim's not wrong. Big Jim presents the live. First of all,
live stream.
Absolutely,
brilliant.
That it should be a pay per view. Where don't even let us edit it. I wouldn't. No, what do we do? Do
listen,
we edit,
I've got
we
a lot of ideas.
Or we
for
just
it.
Let these two.
I've got a lot of ideas for it that we're going to need to talk off air that we're going to launch. But the main part is we have our two stars, we have our idea, and we have our producer. So we're good to go.
We do. Big Jim's in. I assume he's in.
Yeah, we got John from New York.
Is he texting you, Christine?
John from, and we got Black Lou. We got several producers.
Everyone's on board.
Do you want to talk to John from New York, see if he has any cred?
John, coming on as a producer, welcome to the project, John.
Well, I thank you.
As a fellow producer, I welcome you on board.
Yeah, I look forward to, you know, taking a look at this thing and making sure the show launches right. But, you know, I think we got a lot of pieces here.
I only had one request. I think you need to limit Lou to 3 cigarettes a day, so he's very cranky, but also you have that aspect to piss Jacob off.
Can I tell you right now, I like where John's coming from.
I tell you, if you give him five, that's going to drive him bananas.
Yes. I would go up to five, but I like the idea. The idea is a great concept.
Taking away some of the things you love.
Yeah.
Taking away some cigarettes from Lou and fresh air from Jacob.
Yeah. Smoking inside. Air from Jacob. Cigarettes from Lou.
Jacob's pissed that everyone in the world is on board with this. So I assume Christine couldn't think of this as a better idea if we tried.
I'm super excited. I love the idea of moving into reality TV space. That's pretty exciting, and making Lou and Jacob stars.
I love
reality
it.
TV space.
I do. I think we move into the reality TV space, and then we move back into on-screen scripted with Quan Mills.
I really do think that's a gold mine.
What, Quan Mills?
Yeah. I mean, those movies do great.
Yeah.
There are certain things I know would drive Lou insane that I don't want to put him through me either.
It's not for free.
I know what,
Jacob.
Certain things that
you're going to buy that ranch in Colorado. Three seasons you're buying that ranch in Colorado.
Easy. Easy.
I'm gonna be in Norway getting my facial surgery done. That's illegal in the United States.
Big Jim's gonna have to partner
my
up.
By cheekbones.
By season three, Big Jim's gonna have to partner up. He's not gonna be able to afford you anymore. You're gonna be a reality star, Jacob.
Yeah, you're gonna have your offshoot on Bravo, the Jacob Hour.
Jacob, you are everybody's favorite person on the bonfire.
And meanwhile, Lou and Will are gonna have their own bar chain open up in New Jersey
for sure. Lou and Will, so we never have to split.
Yeah. You ever tried their cigarette butt macaroni and cheese?
You ever have a different fist from each twin pouring you a drink in the same bottle?
Dual pour.
Yeah, they could live their whacked out dreams, which I assume is that place they already currently live in.
And Jay and I will just be behind the scenes, just there as your friends.
Stoking the fires.
Sure, I'm going to start getting into like safari wear.
Oh.
And I'm going to be like dressing weird. And after my Norwegian facial surgery, you won't recognize me.
Oh, me and Dan will probably help. We'll chop her in for one of the weekends and pop it. Like, that'll be fun for the show.
Yes.
It's the day that me and you show up to kind of mediate what's going on there.
But then it's going to get kind of weird when I'm addicted to Zicam.
Sure.
And you guys can't stop me from trying to fight colds.
Yeah, the first addiction to homeopathic medicine.
This guy's airborne intake.
This guy's insane. It's just herbs.
It's doing nothing. But look at his eyes are dilated.
Guy's feeling it. Somebody's jittery. Yeah. On his jaw. And then me and Dan got to show up to like stoke the fires a little bit, but also let you guys one-on-one us again so you can say more horrific things about each other that will eventually, on the reunion, and on the reunion, you guys be prepared. May fight.
Listen, you don't do a radio show in Andy Cohen's studio for 5 years and leave not knowing a little something about reality television.
J-Wow,
yeah,
backfisted the situation in his mouth. I mean, busted him as hard as she possibly could.
And that's Eddie Kingston's finishing move in AEW. So that's a real-life wrestling move she did.
And they've been to each other's weddings since. You guys will get past this feud.
Honestly, you guys are going to sit back and laugh, counting cash as Lou lights cigarettes with dollar bills.
We might stop after season three because I don't want, and it's kind of what happens with these shows sometimes, I don't want it to get where you guys are putting on a show.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
I want the genuine that we cannot live together energy from the two of you. This is a gold mine.
Yeah.
I don't know if I've had a better idea.
I can't think of it.
I'm throwing a hypothetical at you because I know myself. It's 1 o'clock in the morning. We're sitting on the couch and I start doing my resistance band training in front of you. What's your reaction?
Holy shit. Why do you need to do yoga every second of the day, guy?
Oh my God, he thinks it's yoga.
This is beautiful.
He thinks resistance bands are yoga.
Oh my God. I'm going to get Myrtle a gold collar.
See, this is already.
Oh my God. I'm going to get that gold collar.
I'm going to buy a fur house.
But my fur house is the funniest thing in the world. All right, let's take our first break. You guys, I think we're making headway. This is brilliant.
Take it, take it.
Jay, I really apologize for when I said that you don't have a production bone in your body. I was drunk, and I didn't mean it.
Jay, take it in.
That's why you're going to be a PA on set.
Oh! Hey.
That's not nice. I don't PA no more.
I don't want you getting in the way of my production.
White Lou is sick. And Jacob is here with a mask on.
Just another day at work.
Just another day at work.
The last time you exercised was gym class. You were graded.
Ooh.
That's how long ago it's been since you've...
You have no compassion, you... It's like me punching you in the neck, you...
You got no...
No, scumbag.
How come
you know why? Because you deserve it.
No.
You deserve it, you little scumbag.
No,
you deserve it.
I told you to exercise because it's good for you.
How come you don't have more compassion? You don't have more compassion?
I can't breathe and you're chastising me saying I'm
no,
out of shape.
No, I'm not.
F*** you. Sit-ups is not going to cure me.
I said, why don't you exercise? You think that's never is going to do...
Because I can't breathe.
Lou, you put yourself into this position.
I can't breathe now.
I'm not talking about now. I'm talking about in general.
I can't breathe yelling at you, stupidity.
Well, you asked me. You said, what should I do? And I told you, take care of yourself. And then you said, what?
Guy, I'm taking vitamins. What do you want me to do?
Vitamins.
Taking vitamins.
Go swim with sharks, you fool. So far from reality. You had a major operation, you go swim with sharks. What do you know about health?
Lou, take care of yourself. Is that...
You don't take care of yourself.
That's what
You
asked me what I should do. I said,
I'm just saying, why? I shouldn't have asked you. You don't know anything. What do you know? You have a major. And your first thing that you do is to go swim with sharks.
Will you swim with sharks?
A few moments later.
Jacob, that's like saying.
Unnatural. I can't.
But if you have an ailment, if you're in your neck brace and I'm flicking you in the neck, isn't that going to bother? Is that going to make it twice the same?
I'm not physically touching. Get out of here.
I'm having a physical problem and you're bothering me.
I'm sitting here and...
You're heckling me while I'm having a problem.
What did I do?
You did nothing.
Man, I remember being there that day. Those guys were going off. I think Andy instigated the whole thing, but that's just me. They want to put me as an instigator on the show. Andy did a lot of that instigating on his own.
I'm wearing this because it actually bothers me.
This is good for my lungs. Just keep
this
going.
This is actually bothering me. You don't think it? You think it doesn't affect me mentally? It drives me crazy.
It does, but physically it's bothering me.
I'm just listening.
Yeah, but it's like it's like in Dumb and Dumber when the guy's dying and he takes the pills.
I don't care.
Pills are good. Like you're just laughing at me. You're mocking me.
I'm not laughing you at all.
Well, it's bothering, like, you're not helping.
I feel bad for you, and I feel bad for me.
Yeah, you're being selfish.
You're the one that's being selfish. You don't
what'd you have me do besides do...
I told you, change your life around.
Push-ups. I can't do pull-ups. I can't do pull-ups to fix this.
You won't even try.
That's not going to help me. I can't breathe.
Not right now, in general, Lou.
All
right,
we'll do calisthenics later, but what would you like me to do now?
I'd like you to stop coughing, but you can't, so there's nothing.
Thanks for the input,
smartass.
Got any more brain busters? Thank you for the input.
I'm wearing my mask because you can't stop coughing.
You are no help. Exhausting. Glad we talked that out.
Good hang.
Jacob's frazzled. He does not want to do this idea.
We'll move on to the TI stuff.
We'll move on. Moving on.
But... It's $1 billion idea.
It's a $1 billion
I'm
idea.
I'm Dan Billion Soder, I'm telling you.
If anybody knows, it's Dan Billion Soder.
He's a guy that's drank several cups of coffee at Craft Services on set of Billions. It's a $1 billion idea. I love you,
fucking
Remy.
Fucking pussy.
Whoa.
I won't kill people with this whole story again, but just to back up how great of an idea this is, even though Jacob's not here, we have now pitched an idea for a show. Called the Odd Thruple, where we'll be... Have you heard about this?
Yes.
I
can be more invested in...
It's what an unbelievable idea. And now it's an Odd Thruple with Black Lou now being there also to instigate these two having like deal with each other.
I'm not trying to take work away from you. I don't even think you need an instigator. After sharing an office with those two for years.
Look,
one cough from Witzky
sometimes
will set him in a downward spiral.
Sometimes you
don't
need a fluff.
Be Andy. You don't be Jacob or be Lou.
That's why I had
Andy.
To sit between them.
Yeah.
Because your piece, you just put on your jam music.
But can you picture what an amazing show that would be?
Yeah, it's amazing. Like I said, financially.
DJ
Lou's really.
I think we bring Black Lou in to instigate. For most of the week, and then we have a special healing session with Andy on the last day.
Yeah, maybe a recap.
I don't mind that.
To be
a recap episode
to bring him back to the office.
A recap episode for sure, but we have a reunion show where they're going to hear all the stuff they said
in the confessionals.
And they're going to be dressed very sexy.
And they're there? What, like, in real time? Yeah. Great idea.
And you just show the time that Lou just said that horrific thing about Jacob when Jacob thought Jacob had a tender moment with him and he went in the thing and just drunkenly went, gay.
And then look, and then Jacob.
He's like, I told you I'm afraid of becoming my father. Failure.
Yeah, then he's like, that hurt. I told you.
I finally drawn the line.
Yeah.
Yep.
But what that's led to right now is we were like, oh, they should have to cook for each other at this cabin. And Lou said he makes casseroles.
Jacob said he refused to eat. Jacob said he refused to eat anything Lou cooked. I mean, this is all on Thursday.
Jacob's
show.
A 3-star Michelin chef.
Yeah,
yes. You're getting
a great meal.
A fucking casserole whisky over here.
So Jacob's getting a fucking grilled cheese made on an iron.
So to set it out, Lou dances with the devil known as casseroles.
And Jeff, what kind of casserole?
So he's going to bring in a tuna casserole tomorrow.
Tuna casserole. First Jacob says he will not touch. He said under any circumstance.
I wouldn't either.
But we're all going to eat it.
I'm going to eat it.
I'm going to eat it too.
Day old tuna casserole?
Day old? You're assuming thing hasn't been in Whiskey's fridge for 4 months.
Wait a second, Lou. I didn't even think about that. Is this casserole sitting in your fridge currently and you're bringing us pieces of old casserole or are you making a casserole?
I want you to hold
up. You're making it from fresh?
Lou, can you hold up a paper? Can you hold up a paper and take a picture when you make the casserole?
I will, yes.
With the date on it?
Please. I didn't even consider giving us old tuna casserole.
I need you to timestamp that photo.
I assume it's going to be sitting in a refrigerator that they don't know what the right number of fridge temperature is, so it's going to come in frozen.
You do not go out to a store and buy it and try and mask it as your own.
You can't buy a tuna casserole in stores.
Yeah, where the fuck are you going to get a tuna casserole?
I don't know how you make
casserole.
A casserole. With that love. That's how you make it. That's complicated for you.
With love.
Who's selling a tuna casserole?
I don't know. That's how little I know about casseroles.
If your mother serves you a frozen tuna casserole that's been already prepped and cooked, then doesn't care. Your mother, she's an alcoholic and probably a drug addict.
Is that not adding up so far?
Oh, yeah, shit.
Now, listen, I think Lou's going to bring in a wonderful tuna casserole that I'm going to have.
Jack Daniel's sauce.
it's like Fridays. I got a Jack Daniel's sauce.
You know, Fridays lost their Jack Daniel's thing. So now it's called bourbon sauce.
Well, it was Evan Williams, I think, they had for a little bit.
Oh, really?
They had something crusty.
Yeah. Wild turkey sauce?
Wild turkey rules.
Wild turkey.
Wild turkey does not rule.
I drank a bottle of wild turkey 100 proof. I went to a house party at Arizona State. I was a problem.
Yeah.
I don't remember if that was a fucking problem.
It sounds fun.
A bottle.
Shout out Kristen Corey. Let me sleep at her house because I was fucking banged up.
What's in a casserole, by the way? That was not a Fiore family thing.
You're going to find out on Thursday.
We're having a party, man.
A couple guys having a party, man.
Oh, man. I love that Lou loves it.
He does.
I love your guys' relationship. I just love you guys.
Oh, yeah. I mean, the things... don't think that things... I've been thinking about it. Like, what I think we should be called the Odd Thruple, the reality show now. Here's where I'm at. I forgot. I've been thinking about this a lot, and somebody's not bringing it up on air for whatever reason. Now I like Black Lou is with you guys, but he's the instigator.
I'm in.
He's the instigator.
Black Lou said I'm in.
Like he makes sure you guys get in situations where he can already tell. Like he'll see that Lou left something gross in the fridge, and then he'll be the guy to point it out to you,
know how
Jacob.
Black Lou, I'm pretty sure, will be able to ask those leading questions.
Yeah.
So good at it, too.
Yeah,
he
wind
me up on the texts when I'm leading up to coming back here.
Yeah.
He would text while the show's going on. Dude, I have my hood on. It's so cold right now. I can't feel my hood. He wound me up for like a month leading up.
And then Jacob's just in Florida letting the sun kiss his face.
Oh, God.
Soak in all the vitamin D.
What the hell's happening back there?
Ah.
That's so fucking funny.
I love it. I love that a thruple idea.
Yeah, and I like the name. Bonfire presents the Odd Thruple.
I think it's great.
And then, he can instigate. It's just a... dude, it's a week.
Week of your life.
Dude, it's a week.
It's a week of your time for a lifetime of memories.
Can I say...
I'm thinking beach house. I think we do a Jersey Shore style. Maybe a beach house or a cabin, like a Poconos thing.
Yeah, we gotta put it in it's got to be a home game for Jacob.
Absolutely. Jacob, I promise you, the surroundings will be exactly what you want. The sleeping situation you're going to hate.
Which is, you think I'm going to be in the same room.
Yeah, it's the show.
Yeah. I'm hearing you.
I'm trying to watch Jacob refocus his powers.
Jacob, you know the show's going to be a hit. I don't want to blast it over the head, people. It'd be a great show. DJ Black Lou instigating you guys to be in nonstop confrontation.
So set it up, dude.
He's so good at it.
You know what,
bothers
Jacob,
him, but he manages to wind me up.
If you guys are in fights,
no one else.
If you guys are in fights at all, you and DJ Lou are arguing enough, there can be an alternative place for you to sleep. But it's got to be like a hilarious, like in a closet mattress or something,
or just like a bunch of things that you fear in as like wallpaper. You know, like a clown room.
Yes,
you can like sleep in the clown room,
or it's just a or a room.
Oh, there you go. We got a clown room.
I was gonna say, really, you sleep amongst dolls? Okay.
They're in the same family.
I put them out of the room, Jay.
Huh?
I put them out of
the room. I swear to God, I thought you said I let them out of the room. Like, that's a weird way to put it. At night when they come alive, I just release them to the world. I can't sleep around those things.
I can't do that. I love this idea.
Yes. It's a killer idea.
Man. I was just in Jacob's office. Fucking pigsty.
Really?
So I think he's going to put up with me.
Yeah.
My office is not a pigsty. My office is currently the Bonfire Museum. So I, for some reason, nobody. I got everything that was collected over 7 years. So I don't know what to do with it.
Wait, really?
And our stuff is my office is now a quarter of the size that it was.
I think we should go like a Lost Tapes. I don't know why I couldn't think of Lost Tapes. We should go up there with like a mics and go through all of it.
Well, we should do if it's really stuff like. I mean, we want some stuff, obviously, one-of-a-kind things, but we should auction off stuff for like charity or something.
Well, I was going to bring it up because I literally have no space.
Well, we're doing it now.
Okay, space.
We didn't mean that.
Think of the office you're going to be able to get. Think of the importance in SiriusXM family that you guys go up, particularly this crew here, goes up when you have a successful show of you guys just going to work on each other in the woods, Jacob, where there will be fishing. It's just Lou's going to be smoking and fishing next to you.
I won't let them eat the filters, the butts. I'll put the butts in my pocket.
I don't believe any of that. I think he's going to throw a can with three straws in the fucking in the lake.
Fishing by a lake is my happy place. Mm-hmm. And now you're permanent. It's like you want to scar it.
Well, no, it's just one trip.
It's just one time that DJ Lou's going to come fish with you.
You guys are missing a good place now, like we've never had before. I feel like we're in the best place we've ever been in.
But you guys are missing the secret sauce, dude. Campaign.
Yeah, don't forget. Campaign, which is going to be the official sponsor. You think we're not going to booze you guys up like Bad Girls Club?
Yeah, dude.
No, we're going to get you guys hot.
You don't think... we're going to make Witski look like he ate Grimace. His teeth are going to be purple.
But Witski's not going to be... his canned wine drunk is not going to be what you think. It's not going to be aggressive. You're going to get furious as he is letting it all roll off the shoulder.
Oh, my God.
You don't give a fuck. You go, can't you just at least clean up after yourself? He's like, he'll be like, that's why you're here, Jacob. Listen to him, bitch, now.
If we can get our shit together, we'll have a sob can for Lou when he's just a couple fucking campaigns in. I miss Will. I'm going to say it. I miss him.
And what's the isolation of them? No cell phones for sure, but there will be. No. Jacob. Yeah.
Just our company. Each other.
You can make phone calls on a landline phone that they have there, but you can't go on computer.
Like old school Real World, where they'd be sitting there talking on
real
the phone.
Like every day. That's what still Jersey Shore still does that. Yeah, no cell phones on Jersey Shore. It's all, you got to be in the moment there. You can get on the quacking duck phone, as they do on Jersey Shore, and you can call, your family and cry or whatever it is that you guys need to do.
I know you want this.
So
and
bad.
I know, and even as a producer, I know it's a good idea, but as a human being,
it's a great idea.
I can't put myself through it. Lou and I, don't forget, we shared an office for, I don't know, 7 years or something, 10 years.
Remember.
Mm-hmm. I mean, there's video of us in the biggest fight, like a raging fight at each other.
Yeah.
And who wants to revisit that? Well,
everybody.
You do.
Everybody in the world.
Everyone that pays
Christine
monthly.
Jumped on that.
All of us.
Yeah, everybody. But you guys will come home stronger for it because this time when you argue, it's going to raise your tax bracket, dude. This thing is going to be successful. You guys are an actual odd couple. And then we take this odd thruple thing.
Who's paying us?
Huh?
Who's paying us?
God.
Dude. You'll see.
TBS.
Let's get the
If you show me a figure.
We have to have the money first.
What? Oh, you're going to pay me afterward.
I was going to pay. We would pay you when we find out what the revenue is going
to
come
see,
from.
See, we got to take we the tapes and take it to the record company. To the record company.
I'm sure the magic on that tape is yours, Jacob.
Yeah.
You don't fucking get it.
That sounds like a YP, not an MP.
No, what I'm saying is completely correct. It's we have to film it. We have to have the project, and then someone will buy that project. Or we put it on YouTube and do advertising. There's a million ways to handle
it. We do it on OnlyFans, and you guys get nasty.
Yeah, we get the after hours cam. You watch Lou beat off the loud pornography in the bathroom.
Or you guys do like a couple stepbrother things, you know? No, it'll be... Listen,
if
YouTube...
You say we actually make money, I have to think about it.
I think you'd actually make money.
Sponsored by Campaign?
I do believe you'd actually make money, for sure.
You guys are going to be filled with canned mimosas and rosé, just learning how to be better friends.
I wouldn't waste time if I didn't think it was going to be anything, right?
Oh, I'm just having fun spitballing, but yes, I also agree with Jay. It did find its way into a great idea.
Mm. Yeah. It was born a
you
great
guys are,
idea.
He's right. You are literally the odd couple.
Yeah. You're the actual thing. How many times you're going to wash your hands until you see skeleton.
Yeah.
I love washing my hands.
I know you do.
I know you do.
And you know and who you know loves what? Dirtying up your hands?
Lou.
This psycho over here.
Loves
I
ripping butts.
Deal with,
yeah.
See, I'd be...
Dude, I hope you
I
have to walk by DJ Lou
I
having
am.
Landline phone sex with his chick.
Oh, yeah?
Jacob, you freak, stop staring. Hang on, babe. Jacob's
hold
trying
on,
to get
let me take another
trying to get his peek at my hose.
Hold on, I'm trying to take a swig of this rosé to keep my tube strong.
Yeah.
See, stuff
Black Lou, come get this fuck.
There's stuff you're not even thinking about that I know would set him off.
Go ahead.
Like, if he's on the phone and he's talking and coughing, the first thing I'm going to do when I take the phone is wipe the phone.
Is that
going to
bother
and
you?
Isn't that insulting? But I'm going to every time.
Okay. And there is the show.
Yeah.
Do whatever you want, Felix.
But then,
and
his,
I don't like coming
but
off
in
like
his confessional,
Felix, in
his
but I guess in this case.
In his confessional, though, he's gonna go like, okay, like you washed the phone after me. But in the confessional, he's going to really be like, who does this fucking guy think he is? Well, Mike, Mr. Do-to-do over here.
My question to Black Lou is, are you prepared to be the housemate that they both download all the drama on? Are you willing to...
Did you confess he jumped up when he was like, I'm in?
But yes. Here's the thing. Of course, sounds fun, but the realization that you're going to have a fucking hammered Lewitsky telling his side of the story, stopping, repeating the beginning, jumping to the end,
we get
starting to the are you
eight
are
to
you,
10 episodes in 1 week of filming with that easy.
Yes. I mean, we could put it on a YouTube channel easy.
Yes.
15-minute episodes.
Everything's on YouTube.
Yeah, you're right.
You don't make money on
YouTube. Bullshit.
What are
you talking about?
I mean, when I hear it, like a comic has
Norman
a million downloads, and they made nothing.
Because they didn't put advertising on it. They make money if they put advertising on it.
Yeah, you put advertising on it. Before Rogan went to Spotify, he was making like $90,000 an episode because of ads on his YouTube.
Yeah.
No, now you're talking.
So this show, sponsored by Onnit.
Dan,
yeah, get ready to take some Alpha Brain, dude. We're going full
Dan,
fucking...
Alpha Brain.
I'm listening.
Yeah. To get ready to, we're gonna, Jay and I are gonna make our own supplements and sell it.
Jacob, forget
it's called beta brain, it's called stoner brain. You're like, no, this actually makes you forget trauma.
We put this out,
I passionately,
we
don't
put this out, and
go
you just get
this.
You get small advertising dollars, the re up, because that's what you do. Then someone picks it up. Maybe Netflix sees this and goes, oh my god, this is
these two. Who are these
a
two?
A wacky fucking thing, or a Paramount Plus.
I've heard that HBO is an aggressive buyer right now.
Mm.
Listen, Nikki got that F-Boy Island. We could probably get...
Nikki's got a reality show coming on E! Channel, too.
Yeah, look, she's parlayed it. That's all we need to do.
This isn't an E! Show.
No, Doug,
no.
This is E! Maybe.
Far from E!
Look, Jacob, we could pay-per-view this right on our websites. I'm telling you, there's a way to make this work.
We can have Lainey fucking... What are those planes?
Fire a few porn stars.
That's what I'm saying. What are those planes that land on water?
Oh fuck! Damn it! Seaplane, I think.
Is this a seaplane?
Are there guests allowed? Like Michelle's? I'm sorry.
Yes, I will release. We will have Lainey release 5 or 6 porn stars. You guys have to wrangle because they. You think Lou's bad on canned wine? Let me tell you what a bunch of fucking.
Yeah.
a bunch of fucking Lainey porn stars on canned wine is going to be interesting.
We should do one thing where they hunt for Jacob.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. We'll set you. That's them. They're coming for you, Jacob. Like, then, oh no!
Yeah.
Oh no!
And then, yeah, that'd be fun. Listen, we could make it, we could do a whole thing. Bert got to do the cabin.
It turns out that Jacob's. That's Jacob's whistle makes that girl noise when he blows. He goes, yeah, just chicks cheering.
That'd be fun. Listen, you know it's a good idea.
I like my space.
I know you do.
Jacob, it's
but sometimes it's good to move out of your space.
You know how long a week is?
Yeah, 7 days.
You two, I mean.
We'll do 5 days.
Dan, you could do this. You could do this, Jay.
Yes.
Yeah, no problem.
Fuck this.
But
I've done things.
Lovely cabin.
What are you talking about? I've like filmed things if I didn't want to like. Do much things I didn't want to do.
Oh, somebody just recently put up your transgendered commercial.
Yeah, was it a transgender commercial? You think I'm psyched about that? I mean, yeah. Did I rock those heels? Yeah.
Dude, I did an entire series on Yahoo called Mansum.
Yeah,
Dan's Mansum. You think I'm proud of that?
Yahoo!
But this is... That's a show, like, you're going home afterward. This is me, like, I have to live my life for a week.
I had to go to Atlantic City for 5 days because of that show. Now. You think I wanted to stay in Atlantic City for 5 days?
Oh, my God. Have you ever seen Atlantic City off the boardwalk?
Everything's wet. Everything is wet.
Foxhole Celebrity Weekend. Oh, Christ. Shout out, Foxhole.
Oh, here we go.
I bet you would have done this for Jamie Foxx, no questions asked.
No questions.
I had a picture with, I never told you this, I got a picture with Idris Elba there.
Nice.
He was at the Foxhole after party.
Damn. Ooh.
Shout out Foxhole.
Didn't he used to be a door guy at Caroline's?
Yeah.
I just knew he was Stringer Bell at the time. I didn't realize he was a sex symbol that everyone loved him. But he's
such a big penis.
He was cool. He looked right at me and said, this guy's a Wire fan. And he nodded, and I got the picture.
This guy's a Wire fan. And Jacob went, I am.
I am.
Yeah.
I'm exactly what you think I am.
Now think about it, Jacob. Think of the little Easter egg now when you hang your signed picture of Idris Elba above your bed on Odd Thruple.
Mm.
Yeah. It's funny. You get to create your own space in this multi-person bedroom.
Everyone has a corner.
All three of us are sleeping in the...
Yeah, dude.
Do you snore, Lou?
Only when I drink.
And guess what? Well, that campaign.
You drink.
When campaign. I'm with Lou, I drink.
If hard. Campaign is sponsoring this.
No. I feel like he's become Lou's thing. Guy.
Might let Black Lou have his own sleeping space.
I like it.
It doesn't. It leaves more room for like. Here's the thing: when you guys go to bed, you might just like piece things up on your own, and then the next morning, Lou starts over again, informing you of what Lou did again. And he goes, "This guy keeps night. He's letting those shit streaks on the bowl every fucking morning. He doesn't care."
Oh God damn it! I didn't think about any of that.
Yes, there'll be one toilet.
Yes,
but no. It's going to be in a beautiful. Beautiful, actually, natural setting.
Yes, but Black Lou also may have his own soaking tub, beautiful bathroom.
We just straight up might just give him a different house.
Yeah. We may just show up every morning to fuck with you guys and leave.
Knife and leave.
We might keep you guys like Fresh Prince of Bel-Air. You and Lou live in the pool house like Will and Carlton.
You understand. I'll give you an example. Like Lou and I walked out last night after the show.
Yeah.
And I had to dump the ice out of the pitcher in the bathroom. He went in, and immediately there was somebody, you could tell somebody was in the stall making a duty. And it stunk so bad, I Lou, I got to go. And I made an about face and I left. I couldn't even be in there. Isn't it absurd, the idea that you're breathing in somebody's ass air? Like, it's so crazy to me.
I never thought that, although I said I do not enjoy in person other people farts at all.
I don't either.
Lou, you like Mexican?
I do, but I hate farts as well.
Oh, all right. That might be the same.
I know
grace.
We're good on, Lou and I are the same on that. Like, he won't do that to me, and I won't do that to him.
No. That's you know cool. what? That's a great place to start from, isn't it?
So you guys running outside to go fart in the middle of the night?
Yeah.
I'm hoping is cowboy pajamas every night with little butt flaps? I want you guys to dress like Muppet Babies.
If Lou doesn't sleep in a Bail Bonds shirt, I don't want any part of this show.
Yeah. Lou, I want you to have comfies that I think are hilarious in some way.
No, I want Lou just being like Umbros in a Lotto shirt. Just going out for a cigarette and flip-flops.
Lou, what are your comfies?
I'm not really that comfortable of a person.
No, really?
Man, that might, be isolated. That might be the best drop.
Your jeans till bed?
I'm not that comfortable of a person.
Yeah, sometimes I'll wear my outside clothes to bed.
What?
To bed?
What? What is that even?
Well, that's an in-ground trampoline, but this is a different thing.
I had a picture, really, not even a bottom sheet.
Oh, there's no chance.
No, just, I take care of sheets.
Yeah.
Top sheet?
But do you...
Or just a blanket?
Do you have like a pair of shorts? Like, I go home, right? I go home and I'll probably take Myrtle out to the park and then I'll come home and put on a pair of sweatpants that I love more than anything. That I got... during the pandemic, you don't have that.
I don't have that, no.
You just come home and lay down in your jeans like you're working on a ship.
You just go to bed in a button-down shirt over a t-shirt every night?
Do you?
Yep.
That's insane.
We need to buy Lou some sweat.
Are you an assassin? Who just sleeps like that? Are you constantly on the run?
You're looking at his chilling on the couch.
That's crazy.
But you don't have like basketball shorts and like a big t-shirt that you put on?
So every day is come to work in your pajamas day?
No, my clothes are clean. I just take off yesterday's shit.
That's crazy. That's going to be really funny to see Jacob in like bed clothes. What's your comfies, Jacob?
I want to like say a terry cloth robe. Do you have a robe?
No.
Okay.
I like wearing... Well, I wear sweats. Mm-hmm. I've never worn basketball shorts.
What? Why?
Well, first of all, they're so long that I look like I'm. You
slept over your boyfriend's house?
Yeah, I look like I'm wearing a dude's basketball short.
Hey guys, Tyler went to go get his ham and cheese. Hey guys, Tyler's not here right now, so I'm just going to be chilling in his bedroom.
That's something I'm so proud of, is that I've never ever become a girl that wears my boyfriend's basketball shorts around the house.
Why?
Because it's just not a good look.
Why? You don't want to be on Team Slut? It rules.
Well, or boxers.
Boxers?
Yeah.
You've never wore boxers. Boxer briefs?
Yeah.
You've never worn what? Boxers or
no,
boxers?
No, I'll wear them. I'll wear sweatpants or boxers.
Okay.
To go to bed?
Yeah. Or I'll wear... Or sometimes I don't wear anything to bed.
Straight naked?
Naked.
Damn, dude. I've said that. You sensual
dude,
man.
You guys should both sleep naked in different beds.
Depends how good looking I feel.
Hey, if you're feeling sexy.
Sometimes I work out right before I go to bed, and if I'm pumped, then I'll go to bed.
Oh, hell yeah. You want to feel it.
Yeah.
Sit back and flex, dude, it out, make your chest move a little bit.
Dude, you just know that there's no... That it's
you don't
want
to hide it. Yeah. You want to see it.
And you're fucking thriving right then.
Yeah.
So why not? I get it. I usually get stoned and eat a bunch of shit at the end of the night, so I always go to sleep in a t-shirt because I'm ashamed. Because I'm fucking ashamed of myself.
What a little stink ass.
Yeah. And then in the middle of the night, I go... And I pull it off. And I go, it's getting erotic.
I think I have more comfies than I have normal clothes.
Yeah, dude. The fact that Whiskey does not have comfies. Come on.
Whiskey has no comfies is crazy.
It's crazy.
Maybe I'll sleep in my underwear when it's hot in the summer.
Oh, perhaps okay. I'll take my shoes off.
All right. I'll unbutton the sleeve or two if it's hot. Wait, you'll sleep in your clothes?
I'll take off this top Spanish shirt.
When you sleep with your chick, but you sleep in fucking pants.
Well, I don't sleep with her every night, and she makes me take off the outside clothes.
Good, good. That's very good.
What do you mean she makes you take them off? Like, why wouldn't...
Would you sleep in jeans under the sheets?
Yeah. Certainly.
Shut up, dude.
I don't really care about it.
I fell asleep in jeans on the couch the other day, and I was, like, mortified that I slept in my jeans. I couldn't believe it.
It's not comfortable, I'll admit.
Dude, why are you doing this?
It's not a joke.
He's not making this up.
I know. I don't think he's making this up at all.
The best way I can explain it was one time I was taking a ride down the shore and I was riding shotgun and the chair was all the way up to the windshield and I never thought to move it back and be comfortable. It was just us two in the car.
That's crazy.
Isn't that weird?
That's nuts.
Lou, start treating yourself.
Oh, my God.
That's pretty wacky.
Black Lou, you've got comfies. What are your favorites?
Yeah. Tight joggers with boxer briefs and a long t-shirt from like 2000s, the long white tee.
Yeah.
Still rock those to bed.
Look at that. That's comfy. You got your comfies on right now, dude.
I'm wearing comfies as we speak.
Yeah.
This is home comfy. That's what I like about Tuesdays.
Home
comfies. When I go home, I'm already in comfies.
Boom.
I'm ready to just plop on the couch.
I did an overnight flight on Thanksgiving, San Francisco to Boston, mm-hmm. Thanksgiving night, wore my sweatpants to the airport. Only time I've ever done that. Pure luxury.
Really?
Pure luxury.
You fly in jeans always?
Yep.
Always. I think that's crazy.
You do?
I do.
Yeah. I'm near you, Lou. I mean, sleeping in a bed's fucking bananas. But I'll sleep on a plane in jeans.
I think traveling in jeans is nuts.
Really?
Yeah.
I got all my pockets.
First time in my life I didn't wear jeans on a plane was last year. And now I love wearing sweatpants on the plane.
It's the only way to do it.
I was so uncomfortable.
Yeah, it is great.
Yeah, up until.
It's the only way to do it.
I just never did it before.
A little crossbody bag.
I got a backpack, dog. I got a giant backpack.
Well, you just yelled at us, pockets.
But I love pockets.
Get sweats that have zipper pockets.
I got all my stuff on me.
She's right.
The sweats I like don't have zipper pockets.
Well, find other sweats with zipper pockets, Dan. This isn't a difficult thing. A little Witsky-ish right here.
Blue? All
they make those? Yeah. What am I supposed to go to China to get them?
I go to sleep in my fly pants, which are my denim. My can't bust them Buddy Lees.
Damn, dude. Why don't you sleep? Is your sheets made out of burlap?
No.
He goes, hey.
Smelly Kikiko that hasn't been washed in a while.
God.
No, don't worry.
Oh, my God.
That's what it smells like, Jacob. Smoking farts.
Yeah. Smoking farts. Right.
Christine decided all of our Kikiko blankets should be dog beds.
You got to smoke in a different room, though.
Shout out Kikiko for dogs loving it.
They love it.
Yeah.
They
do. You should smoke in a different room, for sure. I agree.
Post a picture of Doc and Kikiko.
I'll smoke outside. I'm not a monster.
Yeah, I'll smoke outside.
See?
Oh, God.
Black Lou?
Still going to be all over me. It's going to be my whole essence.
What is your bed your bed right now, at home right now, what is it? Look like
he's got a couple tears from buttons on his denim.
Queen sized, good sheets, fairly clean, probably due for another cleaning. And a Kikiko that fucking smells like a dead camel.
Oh my God,
are you like that, dude?
I don't like the idea of the Kikiko. I guess the others are all right.
He could leave his Kikiko at home.
I could wash it.
Yeah, we'll probably provide bedding.
No hot water.
We'll have bedding for you. This place is going to be furnished.
On the cakey toe.
No, we're going to furnish this place. This place is going to be done up like a...
Real world house
to some degree. It'll be some fun there.
Oh, my God. We'll have Papa Shot, maybe some air hockey, because we're going to want to play that.
I've gotten... We've gotten Airbnbs before in the Poconos that have, like, pool table, hot tub, like all the things.
That's where we saw the ingrown trampoline.
Yeah.
I tell you, I'm afraid I'm going to shut down. When I'm furious and miserable, I'll just shut down and I won't say a word.
You'll
don't think it's going to be good for TV.
It'll be good when you go to your confessionals. I'm sorry, Dan.
Do you go, J-Man, shutting down, boop, or do you just don't want to talk to anybody?
I won't talk.
You're just going to stay in your room.
I've gone silent for a long time, Dan.
Damn, that's scary.
Yeah, but here's the thing. Black Lou's going to be coaxing you into talking.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
That's why he's there.
How do you feel about toothpaste splatter on mirrors in the bathroom? Does that get to you?
Yeah.
I wouldn't do that on purpose.
Yeah.
It doesn't have to be you.
Yeah. Could be Black Lou.
But we'll never know. We could always blame DJ Lou, even if it was Black Lou.
Yes. That's just good producing.
It's going to get you guys stoked up either way. Yeah. And I'll go, you know what? Dude, listen. Here's a can of Peach Mimosa campaign.
Oh, my God, dude. You imagine when DJ Lou has his Get the Let Out back-to-back campaigns. Of rosé, his 3 o'clock rosés. 4 o'clock is gonna be a difficult hour for you. It's the witching hour.
Waking up to the same shitty Pearl Jam song every morning is gonna feel like Groundhog's Day.
Yeah,
is it still Monday? You'll say,
"Oh, where can my baby be?"
I feel like it would get along better if he was drunk, because Lou is the most lovable person when he's got alcohol.
You'll get over it though. When you're three days on the third day of the seven. Is going to be a nightmare day for you. That's going to be the one that's going to suck the most, because you feel like, oh my God, we're not even halfway there. Like, I'm not over the hump yet.
Everyone told me.
Day five, you'll be like, it's cruising.
Yeah. Everyone told me when I did Edinburgh in Scotland, they're like, there's a breaking point. Everyone has one breaking point, like 3 weeks in, where they're like, fuck this, I don't want to do this anymore. And I was like, no, this is fun, you know? And it happens. So he's right.
Oh, yeah.
You're going to hit that moment where you're like, fuck this. What is this? What are we even doing here? This is stupid. And then you're going to get over it. And then you have the time of your life.
Yeah.
I'm not going to.
Yeah. And you know what? This show is going to do well. People are going to want to watch it. You're going to make money. Well. Campaign is going to take off. Jay and I are both, I think we got points on that, both on the back end of campaign. Sure. We agreed on the bonfire. We're family, so we'll get like, you know, 3 or 4%.
At least a taste.
Yeah, just a small taste.
In stores everywhere.
In stores everywhere now. But I'm telling you, this is the show's fantastic. The addition of Black Lou.
Genius.
Is going to put this over the top. DJ Lou is in. Black Lou is in. It's really, we need you on the dotted line, Jacob.
Are you two in it?
Oh, well, we kind of stop by the house.
Oh, we'll also be like, we'll be presenting the thing ultimately.
We'll be doing outside shots, exterior shots. Christine producing.
And then the reunion show where you guys find out what you said about each other.
Yeah, we'll host that.
In the house, in the confessionals, is going to be.
And then we'll probably have Shane as like our Steve Wilkos. You know, just in case shit gets nuts.
He'll tell you that complainers can't sit on my stage and he'll whip that fucking chair.
Yep. He'll throw your chair.
Is it like a Big Brother thing? Will there be live cameras that people can sign in and stream?
I don't know.
We're going to have to find the setup first.
Okay. A pay-per-view would be pretty great. That may be a season two edition.
Yes.
Around, when we have people, they're definitely going to be, do you know what I mean? Make the numbers and that look good. First, we should get the product, a great product. Then we'd say, for extra, if you want to subscribe, you can watch them on like cameras, living their lives.
Yes. You'd, Jacob, you'd be bored out of your mind.
No way. Are you crazy?
Watching you make a knife?
A Jacob Zoo would be fucking wild.
$3.99, I'll pay that.
Yeah, we're going to give you things to do stuff you want to do. It's just, is DJ Lou going to ruin those things?
And you know what we're going to give DJ Lou? Countless cigarettes.
Yeah. And we're going to go... Jacob, do you want to go scuba diving? And then we go. You'll go, yes. And we'll go, we got an awesome dive set up for you, but you have to teach DJ Lou how to do it.
Yeah. Also, you got to get him to eat vegetables. If you can do that.
Also, yes, you have to teach him finishing school stuff, which fork to use.
Yeah, how to balance a book on his head.
I would cook for Lou. But
also, he has to cook for you.
Yeah.
No.
Yeah.
Why? You don't like hot dogs and mac and cheese?
Fucking 1,000% no, I'm out.
It's ramen. It's good.
This is my line.
Could
in the
a
sand.
Bazillion Chinese people be wrong? Doubtful.
Eat it, Brendan Fraser. It's called him School Ties.
Hey, School Ties.
One night you cook.
I eat. No way. I'm eating.
A meatloaf casserole you don't want.
Fuck no.
Meatloaf casserole?
This is what I'm talking about.
You heard
bullshit me. I'm eating any of this.
Hang on a second, Jacob. Give us 1 second here. Meatloaf that's two different dishes.
They may be hot, dude.
Not anymore. Now it's one. The two become
You've
one.
You've never
you
had
think, do you call hamburger helper meatloaf casserole?
What about hamburger helper spaghetti?
All right, it's pretty much hamburger helper.
You don't like
right.
tuna spaghetti? You don't like tuna fish spaghetti? Come on. It's all protein.
Oh, my God.
What is this?
Meatloaf casserole.
No, it's not a real
thing. All right, we'll do tuna casserole, you health nut.
No, I'm not. I don't like tuna casserole.
You health nut. We'll do tuna, you health nut.
You make casseroles? You're like a 50s housewife?
No, there's no way. He's talking about hamburger helper. He doesn't. Do you make tuna casserole?
Of course I do. So easy, fun.
Is that how you and Will cook for each other, casseroles?
He won't eat it, but it's really good.
Isn't it just pasta and tuna fish?
Yeah, and mayo and cream of mushroom soup and cheese on top for that. When we've been good.
Jacob's holding his stomach.
What? Some heavy cream, a little piss.
Peas, there's actually peas in
peas,
there.
Peas, yeah,
that's
peas
healthy.
Makes sense. Jacob, you're getting, Jacob, you get your peas in.
Zero chance I'm eating that.
Should I start making casseroles first?
Shut up, Christine. Yeah. Yes, design your life after DJ Lou.
That inspired you.
She was,
that's
she
fucking insane. You?
She was, Jay, should I start sleeping in jeans? Jay, you might better go to bed fully loaded.
You might better hop in. If I'm hopping the sack fully jeaned.
Hey, Jay. Sorry, express train coming to bed.
I hope it doesn't rub up against your leg and give you fucking seam burns.
Yeah, so you're going to dry hump me like high school and give yourself a nice denim rash.
Damn.
Jacob, you got to eat what Lou cooks.
No, I won't.
My spaghetti
meatballs. No, I don't have to.
My spaghetti meatballs you would like.
The spaghetti meatballs you would like.
No.
Again, everything has meat in it.
Can you use gluten-free spaghetti?
Everything has meat in it.
No. No way.
I think Lou's meatballs, he just like rolls up ground beef and that's it.
Ground beef can be used for many dishes.
No. Wait a second. When you make meatballs, though, do you just make balls of ground beef?
No. There's egg. There's breadcrumbs. Okay. There's spices, which is most onions I like.
Okay. All right.
Baked into the meatball. Fry them in a cast iron pan.
Lou, I'll eat spaghetti and meatballs all day that you cook. In fact, I love the idea of a tuna casserole.
Yes.
Jacob, why you're so against this, I have no clue.
You're making this up for the
I will eat it right now, and I'll enjoy it.
That tuna casserole sounded like a real punch to the gut, but...
No, it didn't. Witzky, look at me, dude. You give me a nice cold can of Canada Dry, I'll walk through that.
I'm telling you, meatloaf
casserole.
I'm
holding you to that. I want to bring it in. I want to see it. I want to see you eat it.
Done.
What? What are we eating?
I'll make a tuna casserole for tomorrow.
Okay.
And someone's going to eat it.
Dan's eating it.
I'll eat it. I don't give a fuck.
I'll try it.
Yeah.
What are we talking about, though? But this is going to air. That's going to air before this airs.
It's okay. We'll set it up tonight.
Yeah.
Okay. Lou's cooking for you.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm going to watch you eat it.
Should I get a can of soda?
Because you're so cool.
I'm not so cool. I just can eat that. I'd love that.
Because he's your cool friend.
Tell me the ingredients again. How do you throw a tuna casserole?
You're not thinking this through, Dan.
Tuna, onion, parsley, cream of mushroom soup, cream of broccoli soup.
What? Two soups?
Yes, because it's gloppy and it brings it together.
That wasn't a good fucking way to put it.
Instead of mayo, instead of mayo, that's what makes it.
You actually suggest, but you last time you said mayo also.
He said it was gloppy.
That kind of
gloppy. By the way, cream of mushroom soup. I was like, yeah, that might be tough. He's like, cream of spinach soup. I was like, oh, Jesus.
I rarely try.
No, listen, I like both of those soups. I'm that kind of garbage for sure. Both of those soups are great. I grew up with cream of potato.
Oh, that's great.
Out of a can. I
don't like
soup, and by the way, cream of mushroom soup, before you scoff,
that's great,
is the part of every green bean casserole you've ever had.
That's what my grandma uses for a green bean casserole.
It's the ingredients.
I haven't had it,
so I know what I'm talking about.
But then you throw in a cream of broccoli when I feel like you could just do broccoli, but you want more cream. Because it uses, and I hate to use a chef's term that you said here, but it glops it together.
Damn, did you pick that up at the Cordon Bleu?
Oh, where'd you get that?
Where'd you pick up that speak? All right, Anthony Bourdain. Why don't you calm down?
It's going to be delicious. You're going to love it, Dan.
Dude, honestly.
There's cheese on top of the whole thing, right?
Yes. So American cheese like you used to get in Colorado.
Yeah, soups, tuna, and cheese, and peas.
And peas.
I don't like peas, but I'll eat them.
You don't like peas?
I don't like peas.
Substitute corn.
No, I'd rather do peas.
Don't do that.
Yeah, do peas. Jacob, you want to have a bite with me?
No.
Jacob, you won't have a bite of this. He's
going to
cook for us. He'll wash his hands for the first time. He's going to make most of it in his bed, though.
My cookware is clean. I wash dishes really good. It's very sanitary. It's just if you like it or not. I'm not going to inject cholesterol in there.
Well, Andrew, put a donut in there also. Just chop up a donut and throw it
in there. I'll tell you what, though. 35% chance there's cigarette ash in the casserole.
Never. I wouldn't even bring the cigarette in the kitchen.
Well, he sings while he's hanging out his bag. What's the matter with you? Hey, what are you going to do? Hey, what's your mouth to leave? What's your mama going to leave?
Tuna. This more looks like a dolphin.
Tuna.
I'm going to enjoy it.
You put the tuna in right out of the can, too, right?
Yes.
It's not tuna. It's not tuna salad, Dan.
Yeah, whatever, dude.
It's tuna-like...
Yeah, let's party.
Right. No mayo.
No mayo. Just multiple soups.
I thought there was going to be mayo.
You won't taste it. I'm telling you.
He said mayo in the first instructions. He did say mayo. Yeah.
But then the Witzky secret ingredient is skip cream the mayo of broccoli. And put another can of cream of broccoli. Yeah.
Yeah. Why but it's probably bad? Good. Probably good. Campbell's soup, right?
Yeah. It's got to be better for you than mayo.
What? You don't want to eat soup that has a rip tab on top? Oh, I'm sorry, fancy ass.
You know what? Bring it, dude. I'm looking forward to it.
I'm going
to
try it.
Great. I think you'll love it.
Yeah, thanks.
I think it's going to be good.
Jacob, and then if we like it, it's on the menu for the show.
Stop doing your nodding thing, Jacob. We're doing a radio program.
That doesn't look good to you. You don't think I can pull that off?
It does. I think, I'll be honest with you, if that was in front of me right now, I'd eat that for sure.
Oh, my God. Cold can of... Ginger ale? Canada Dry ginger ale?
Well, Dan's already washing it down. I'm just going to try it.
I want a whole meal. I'm talking
it's
about.
It's made with love.
He goes, I'll be honest, if I put it in the back of my throat and just chug something on top of it, I probably won't even taste it.
Yeah, dude. It's like when you eat a sick girl's ass.
Is there a breadcrumbs in it?
Would you like that? I can leave them off.
No, no. I'm asking if they're, if is it part of your recipe?
Sometimes they can go wrong. Makes the top too hard.
Oh, I like a hard top, though.
I like a little crust to poke through.
I do.
You got it.
Okay. This is going to be good. It's really good.
I'm excited.
Black Lou, you're going to try it, right?
Yes.
Black Lou's trying it, but you're not going to try it, Jacob.
No.
Why? What's wrong?
Jacob, how about this?
It's not my type of food.
Jacob, how about this? Jacob, I mean this from my heart. If you eat a whole pan of that, I'll drop the entire idea of the odd thruple.
No, I...
All right, you're in the woods then, dude. You're in the woods with the Lou's.
I'm not trying it.
Okay.
All right.
All right. You're in the woods then.
Are you going to be upset that we're just snacking on a nice plate of whiskey tuna casserole?
Yeah, I'm going to be upset.
Yeah, I mean, it's not going to ruin your hot torso.
Yeah, tuna all my teeth.
Mm. I'm going to have to brush before I go home, though.
Oh, yeah.
You just dump all
dance girlfriend
all these...
hits him if he eats tuna.
Yeah.
Is there one thing?
I'm dating Heathcliff. If I bring up tuna, I'll get fucking whapped. Where's the tuna?
I hate tuna.
She just wants to eat it. She's jealous. Yeah, Jacob, it's going to be fun.
Mm.
Mm.
Okay.
Odd thruple, dude.
Well, it's time to...
He's going to love how I cook. I mean, he's getting like a Michelin star chef cooking for me.
Well, don't break your back sucking your own dick just yet. I mean, let the guy make his casserole. Maybe it's delightful.
Oh, Jacob's is... I've had his food. It's good.
I know, Jacob's a good cook. Everything I cook is extraordinarily unhealthy, but it's all very delicious, the things that I can make.
Now you make fish good.
I make fish okay. I don't do anything that amazing with it.
I can't cook
but
shit.
I'm telling you, but like I make a fucking dope mac and cheese, for sure. Stromboli, off the charts.
Yeah, it's good.
But deadly. But they're delicious, and I think Lou's fucking tuna surprise could be not bad.
Yeah.
I'll be blown away if there's no bones. It's canned tuna, guys.
Yeah.
More like canned tuna. I'm working on my more like jokes.
I like it.
Thank you. More like...
Well, you're both going to... Everyone's trying it tomorrow, so I look forward to... I hope you all enjoy it.
Good. Well, we'll
no, you don't. You hope we hate it.
No.
No.
But, I'm just going to see what happens.
Yeah, but you're going to hope that we don't like it.
Can we... How about this? How about in the cabin... on the odd thruple, how about when Lou cooks, you give him like the thing and a recipe and let him follow the recipe to make the thing you want?
Let him be your kitchen padawan.
I could do that.
Yeah. This thing's coming together. It's a good negotiation.
We're really cooking?
Because we do want to have activities that bring you guys together and then watch you organically hate each other. But that's day to night. And then the next day you start over again as besties. Do you even watch reality TV?
Is Will going to miss you? How is Will going to feel about all this?
Oh, he's calling the landline nonstop. Is my brother there? I had a nightmare. Is everything okay?
Wait, I'm curious, Lou. Do you and your brother, like, what do you do for each other? Like, so you cook for him and he'll cook for you?
No, I do all the cooking, but we basically ignore each other. We don't really see each other a lot. It's not like we hang out. We just come and go. We just exist in our genes.
There's no common.
Does he sleep in his jeans too?
Oh, I'm sure. His bed isn't even comfortable.
Really?
Yeah.
His bed's uncomfortable.
Why do you guys choose to live like this?
Dude, come on, dude. Let's get Will a bed.
How old is your mattress?
What did you guys do? Did you guys kill somebody and feel guilt about it? Did you guys kill a retarded girl in high school?
We can get a discount. I don't know if you know this, but we can get a Helix sleep mattress.
Up to $200 off.
I go to Casper, thanks.
Oh, I mean, that's all right. Well, I don't know if I'd say that on the show sponsored by Helix.
Everyone's special, right?
Everyone's special. Take the quiz and realize your producer.
All right, I'll take the quiz.
The odd thruple.
Well, let's take a break.
We will. Let's take a break.
Jacob, these are great ideas. I know you love it.
As a producer, it's driving you nuts how good some of these ideas are.
I am
Jacob,
wrestling with it.
Yeah, Jacob, like you giving the recipe for Lou to cook. Him teaching you how to like make it look like you made your bed.
I'm just imagining
he's gonna get you over things. He's gonna have you like not make your bed one day and see if you like if it's just all. Because by the way, that would me. All day I'd be like, I could just go make it in 2 seconds, and then I feel like I'm not a piece of shit.
And also the highlights of the clips that we get to put in the theme song at the beginning, where it's like you upset that he can't make his bed right. It's going to be great.
Yeah. Most of it, the soundtrack will be me and Dan Reggie watching.
I'm coming in your butt. We're going to take a break. We'll be right back.
Two soups in the casserole.
It is the bonfire.
Two soups. Oh, no. I tell you what does make me nervous, though, is that DJ Lou is about to cook a meal for seven people. It's going to cost him $4 in ingredients.
Yeah. He goes, and a packet of seasoning.
Seasoning.
Everything is a packet in a can. You just mix it all into a bowl.
All right, Jacob. Let's not attack yet. There's no cameras rolling. There's no cameras rolling right now.
I'm not against your healthy lifestyle. I just...
He thinks it's gay. That's all.
So much work. I hate Trader Joe's. Go fuck itself.
Trader Joe's.
You heard me, Christine.
Trader Joe's is the best.
No, it's not. It's just a bunch of lines and Jacob hates germs.
No, it's amazing. I'll tell you what. Local farmers.
Starting to come around and tell you that this Trader Joe's is a bit of hype, right?
No, bit of hype.
Why do you feel that way?
It's a bit of hype. Their stuff's good, but it's just like one store just got a good brand. Some of the things are good. Some of the things are garbage.
They work with different distributors and local farmers to make things.
Trader Christine. What do you buy stock in the joint?
It started in California. It's a great company. They treat their employees well.
What you don't know?
I love Trader Joe's.
They come on all their avocados.
Yeah, Trader. Spread the news.
Spread the word.
Reasonably priced.
Those are just jizz balloons.
There's always a mad dash of like everybody can't wait to get that shit off the shelves. Like there's some gold in there.
I hate their stupid the design around their logo.
C-Town?
Yeah.
What's up, C-Town?
Yeah.
I see you. I see you with your bruised produce. Yo. I see you with your old cookies.
I'm OG Aldi.
Oh, shit. I'll even just shout out to Albertsons. Shout out King Supers in Denver. Shout out Safeway, the true god.
Ralph's like a motherfucker. Ralph's all day.
If you in the South, we got love for the South. Piggly Wiggly, where you at?
Piggly Wiggly was West Coast. Piggly Wiggly. I went to a Piggly Wiggly
in the West Coast. Really?
No, not West Coast. Midwest.
Oh, Midwest.
In Ohio.
Too.
They had them in Ohio when I was younger. When I go visit my dad, I grew up with Acme, Pathmark.
Yeah, mm-hmm.
Stop and Shop and ShopRite. ShopRite was actually like the one besides Acme.
You guys don't have Vons at all?
Vons is a good one.
Is it though?
Vons is great.
Ralph's.
Ralph's, well, Vons, Lucky's, Albertsons.
Prepare Bonfire Lucky's. Campers Group to be bonds with all of your names of your local grocery stores.
I'll tell you right
now.
Wegmans.
I wanted a King Supers
Wegmans is the king.
Hoodie. I wanted, like, you know, you want your local grocery store.
Fairway.
If I could get a Lucky sweatshirt, I would. Because it turned to Albertsons.
Fairway's rules. Fairway's pretty dope.
Grand Union.
I do have thrifties.
Osco Drugs.
This guy.
This fucking guy.
This motherfucker.
All right, we'll be right back.
You're not from Teaneck. You don't know what the fuck I'm talking about.
Let's go,
this guy
Jones.
Buys his ice cream at CVS. That is awesome. Good call, Lou. Lou's going through all the old and current, I guess, intros for every other popular radio
That's
show.
That's what I said. It's going to be fun when he gets to, like, you know, Dingo and Matt. In Cincinnati.
Yeah, where Daddy goes, I don't know what this is.
Yeah, he is.
This is Kid Chris opens his show out in Cincinnati.
Yeah. All right, cool.
I'm sure.
Hell yeah. Welcome to the Bonfire, Sirius XM, Faction Talk 103. I'm Dan Soder. That's Big J. Okerson.
Big day.
Big day. Big day. It's tuna casserole day here at the Bonfire.
Mysteriously, Black Lou couldn't make it in.
Yeah. Black Lou just happened to not be able to come in today when there is a full-on cooked casserole by one Lou Witzke.
Classic Black Lou is what they'll say on the Odd Thruple.
They're like, that instigator.
He doesn't even show up for the thing. He makes these guys agree to a sack race and doesn't even show up.
Yeah. In the studio, we have Christine, Jacob, and DJ Lou at home. Our Black King, the Black Tiger, Lewis.
No. Where is? I don't have Black Lou on my screen.
It's on my screen.
You do?
I don't, though.
Damn.
Hit the Zoom icon.
No, I mean, I have him. It's very small.
There was a part of me that didn't think the tuna casserole was going to make it in today. I thought it's one of those things.
I forgot all about it. I've never been happier.
Yeah, I thought it was one of those things that we always do where we talk shit and then never do it. And today, I'm staring at one. I'm staring at a tuna casserole.
You're not wrong. I agree with that.
Remember that guy that was going to go back and find every subject we never finished, and then that it was just too overwhelming for him, and
it was too many.
It just broke him.
He had to stop.
Yeah, the weight of it was too much, and he couldn't continue on.
Well, guys, it's getting cold over here. So
all right. Serve it up, dude. Right. Serve up this tuna casserole. Now, of course,
this is crazy.
Bonfire context. Ding, ding. You can't do the board and cut it up. I didn't mean to do that to you. Jacob, do you want to run the board while he's setting out slices?
Sure.
Jump on
if
in,
you could.
Dude.
I don't know what you want me to do, Lou.
I want you to play yummy, yummy, yummy. I got love in my tummy when they start eating it.
So, a little bonfire context. We were talking about making an odd couple show called The Odd Thruple with Jacob, DJ Lou, and Black Lou living in a cabin. Obviously, DJ Lou and Jacob at odds with Black Lou as the instigator.
We're trying to think of all the different things we could do to get them to interact and be funny together.
One of which was every other night they would cook. So Jacob would cook one night, the next night DJ Lou would cook, and Jacob
emotionally shut down yet again.
Flat out refused it. I mean, flat out refused it. And DJ Lou said he could cook, and he said he could cook casseroles. He's deep in the casserole game.
Let me tell you how much this casserole means to DJ Lou. He knows us all well enough to know, at least me and Dan would have forgot completely this was even happening.
My God, yeah.
It was already over. I planned lunch today, and it fell through. When I fell through, we just didn't end up doing it, but well, I was going to have lunch.
Jay, when God shuts a door, he opens a window.
He absolutely does.
Hey, Ronnie B!
Ronnie B, please.
Come on
please.
In.
I'm sure he loves casserole.
I mean, I think he would love to know.
I'm excited to explain to Ronnie B what's going on.
Yes.
Mr. Ron Bennington.
Ron Bennington in the house.
When did you guys come back?
We've been back, what? Man. We snuck in through the vents like McClane.
We've been in here since December, and I felt like we've been alone the whole time.
You're just in there hiding.
Look, it's good to see you guys.
Oh, I know, it's great to see you.
I know we're doing a show for...
Sarah.
Sarah from... but I'm doing another one, Bobby, on Monday night.
Okay.
At the Underground, and I really would like for you guys to do the set instead of me. You know, just go down, crush it, you know, yeah, like you do. What's going on with Billions? I'm trying to figure out. Mike Prince is running for president.
Can I tell you honestly? Yeah. I don't know what's going on.
It's really hard to understand. Do you watch at all?
Why would you put them? Why would you do that to me right here?
Okay, that's a really good point.
I'll say I've watched many, many episodes of Billions. I don't know what's happening. I know Dan boxed. That was pretty cool.
That was a while ago, though.
Oftentimes, Dan's sitting and people are yelling over him and he's bouncing a pen on a table going like,
yep.
Yeah, he's upset.
That's my, a bunch. I would say that's my zone. That's where I really get into character.
I can do an impression for you. This is my impression of Billions. Leave the gun, take the cannoli. And by the cannoli, I mean the cryptocurrency that each one of us... Are we constantly...
Vecchione and I used to do Billions dialogue to each other about stuff in the apartment, where I'd go, a full sink. A lot of people think it causes diseases. You know what it's usually the cause? Old food. If you eat my food, you're going to eat it and swallow it. And we just do different monologues to each other.
Well, I felt more, like I said, when I was on set, for the scene that I did, I watched a scene filmed before my scene.
Yeah.
And it was, you could tell it was a scene. It was what's the guy's name? Roland Emmerich?
Yeah.
I mean, no, that's the director. No, that's my favorite director.
I watched it last night, by the way.
Well, he's a good one.
No, that's the, I forget his name. The guy from Truman Show. That was Truman's best friend.
Yeah, from The Americans. I know who you're talking about.
Paul Giamatti?
No. Man, he's good.
It was
too.
Him and Damian Lewis having a scene.
Noah
Emmerich.
Noah
Emmerich.
And it was those two talking, and it was definitely a scene. I was watching it over and over get shot. I go, this is the scene to explain what's going on to a dumbass like myself.
Right.
And I remember the term was, it's a short squeeze. I watched him explain what a short squeeze was. Yeah. I still don't even know if it's in stocks or banking. I don't know.
Yeah.
I don't know what any of it means. And the scene, eight times, going, hey, dum-dums at home who want to follow the show, here's your glossary.
Here it is.
But they quote every other movie.
Yeah.
They quote every movie that exists.
I've had to watch stuff because I didn't know the quote I was doing. Yeah. I was like, oh, okay. I didn't see this movie. So
My Ring's Outside. What is that? Oh, Rocky V.
Are you excited about the Sixers? Do you believe?
I'm very excited about the Sixers. I do believe.
Do
Do you congratulations, believe Joel Embiid, scoring title.
Big. Well, look, you can't say enough good things about Embiid other than the fact he doesn't belong in this country. But you get beyond that, he's just fantastic. Harden, I don't know.
I don't know Dude, either. But I don't know. Hate, do you, I find myself hating Ben Simmons.
Oh, I did. Now I he's in Brooklyn. I'm like, he's pretty good. You know what I mean? But yeah. I'm interested to see him come back, too. I kind of feel about basketball like I don't feel that same connection to team.
Mm-hmm.
Like, where are the good players? That's what I want to watch.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? If I'm turning on Memphis, I'm like, yeah, this is good. Yeah. You know what I mean? I love this kid. But I can't get caught up. It doesn't have the same father-son connection as other sports.
Me and my daughter, it does.
Well, that's good. It's that's very, that's yeah. your thing? Keep that going.
Would you say baseball over NBA for you? Like, are the Phillies more important?
Yeah, yeah. I mean, that's the connection I have with my dad, but Gail watches basketball.
Did you see the guy for the Phillies say, I can't stand
fucking what everybody
says. I can't fucking stand this place.
I said it in the stands in that town.
Yeah, he got an out, and they gave him a sarcastic clap, and he went, I hilarious. Can't fucking stand this place.
DJ Lou's going to start freaking out because his casserole's getting cold. Ron, I'd like to fill you in on what's happening here. Yeah. I have what I believe is a gazillion-dollar idea for a TV show. A running thing called The Odd Thruple, where we put DJ Lou and Jacob, who are already the odd couple.
Right. It's
genuinely Felix and Oscar. And then we throw in Black Lou as the instigator, and we put him in a cabin for a week and watch hilarity unfold. They will not get along for 3 seconds, but one of the things we said was they will cook for each other on alternate nights. And Jacob is a very good cook, a great cook, a health baker, nut too. Also a health nut. And Lou was like, oh, I'll cook. You'll love it. And he said, we asked Lou what he makes. What are his dishes?
Yeah.
He said, tuna casserole. And then described, oh, my God.
Oh, God.
That doesn't look good, Lou.
What? Scary.
Get in here, dude. Oh, man. Bring over a plate, Whitsky.
It looks Let's like AA food. Nuts. I'm going to be honest, man. Hey, dude. I got to rock, guys, but I'm going to say it. I'm glad you guys
Ron,
are back,
Ron, good to see you, man. Great to see you.
Yeah. I'm glad you guys are all
Thanks for
happy.
Holding down the fort.
Yeah.
We appreciate it. Too. Don't forget your bag. No, that's our bag.
That's our bag.
Sorry.
I love you, buddy.
My bag can get you 10 years.
Ron Bennington rules. What's fucking
He got out. By the way, he got out of here before he knew we were going to ask him to try some of this.
Yeah. Yeah, man. So it's shells. Looks like there's some Parmesan cheese on it.
Nope, that is breadcrumbs.
Breadcrumbs.
What?
Jacob.
Can I be honest with you?
I can't even look.
If I saw this at a buffet, I'd take a scoop.
Yeah, me too.
Well, then take one.
All right, here we go.
Yummy, yummy. What are the dots on it, Lou? Pepper?
There's pepper. There's oregano.
Oregano?
Dad likes it.
Yeah. I dig it.
Yeah, it's exactly what I expected.
Yeah,
fine.
It's good. Good job, dude.
You do a lot worse than eating this, Jacob.
Mm-hmm.
Jacob, do you want to take a bite?
No.
You sure?
I'm sure.
Jacob, it's actually extremely rude to not even have a scoop.
Just have a scoop. This guy slaved all over it.
No.
Do you know this guy had to go through?
Come on, dude. It's a party.
He had to call dibs on the kitchen from his twin brother.
He's got a pencil in on the sheet when he can have kitchen time. And then, come on, Jacob. Just get one good bite.
He had to make a non-chorizo meal, which you know pisses off his girlfriend.
Look at this guy.
Are you worried that the Kraft singles are not melted? Because they are.
It's great.
Oh, man. This piece of tuna is not even broken up. I right out of the can right there.
You know what? I think I just tasted something plastic and I enjoy it. No, I didn't. It's fine. You're all right.
It's healthy.
This is good, dude.
I'd say the Jacob, I'd say the Kraft singles are a hiccup.
No.
I'm fine with them.
Christine, no. You take the rest of mine.
What?
I'm taking a bite.
No, but you should just take a couple bites from this.
Jay's trying to give his away.
I've tried many different cheeses and Kraft singles melt the best.
This is like a regular thing for you?
Yeah. Poor man's pasta, baby.
Good. Right?
See, Christine? Black Lou, you're missing out, dude. Jacob? Black
I'll
Lou.
Save you some.
Jacob.
That smells really good.
Jacob, come on. Is that...
Don't even... Jay, don't waste your time.
Dan, what do you think those two white things are coming off the... Dan, take a peek at that shell right there. There's two white things coming off of it.
I think that's,
Tuna strings?
Tuna frack?
You see that?
Oh, yeah, what is that?
What are those two things?
I don't know. You're going to have to get in there and touch it with your hand.
Let me
see. Oh. Is it like shaved Parmesan?
Sure, it's not your fork?
No, you said no Parmesan.
There's no Parmesan?
There's no Parmesan. I asked. I was kind of hoping it was blanketed with Parmesan spread crumbs. But Jacob,
I'm not lying to you. I would just throw this in my mouth, but...
Look at this.
They're all over. I think it's the tuna.
Yeah,
it's tuna splices.
It's tuna.
Uh-huh. That's all, Jacob. There's tuna splices.
Right? I'm telling you, when you're living out there in that cabin, you're going to really enjoy this. This by a lake?
Well, this is hearty, first of all. It's going to be good for you guys waking up and doing Jacob stuff.
If it was like Yellow Jackets, I would eat it. But
might be.
We're not at that point, so...
Not yet. But what if we can't get a rescue plane to pull you guys out of wherever we do this show from?
Yeah, we're going to drop you somewhere with a crew.
Does anybody want seconds?
Huh?
Jay does.
No, I can't possibly. There's so much left.
Yeah, we can't eat on air. It's rude.
The cream of broccoli really gives it the zip, I think.
It's one of the creams.
Can you list your ingredients for everyone, Lou? The recipe?
Peas, 2 cans of tuna in water, not oil, because I'm healthy. 10 Kraft singles.
10 Kraft singles?
2 cans of cream of mushroom. Did I say peas?
Did you do the cream of broccoli?
It's the same shit.
You're just doing it for the cream.
Yeah,
I thought you were doing it for the vegetables.
I'm doing it for the glop.
Wait, did you just say 10 Kraft singles?
Yeah, why do you think it tastes so good?
You put the Kraft singles on top or you just mix them in?
No, that's the final thing.
This is latchkey kid food. Honestly,
I love it.
This is got home from school when you were by yourself till 8 p.m. at least.
I'm ready to watch Total Recall on TBS.
Lay on my belly with a plate of this?
Yeah. It's like, okay.
Eat this. And then have mom come home from work exhausted.
Jacob, a forkful.
Oh, my mom was home when I got there.
All right, well.
I can't help it. I mean,
well, congratulations,
yeah,
dude.
Thank God you.
I'm not bragging.
Sorry, your parents
different
had
lifestyle.
Sorry your parents had you at a reasonable age.
Sorry.
I'm not bragging. I know how it is. I mean,
sorry, my mom's
I know
dead.
I'm fortunate. I'm not, I'm not rubbing it in or anything.
His mother's dead.
Can't.
Is he treating an orphan?
His mother's dead, bud.
Real cool.
Yeah, sorry he didn't. He's not the heir to the campaign.
Is there a Muslim guy trying to break into that studio? Oh, Tino Badai going to do a show. Sorry. Sorry. Well, look. Say something, right?
The first couple of bites, I thought it was, like, okay. And then as I take more bites, I start getting a little grossed out.
Why is that?
I don't know.
Because it's chunked up tuna and Kraft
singles? I think it's tuna. I feel like if it was just, like, noodles and cream and mushroom soup and peas, I'd be less grossed out.
There's no protein, though. Where's the protein? That's the protein. That's going to help you grow.
You think there's bones in this tuna? Because I feel something.
I'm chomping on something.
I don't think bumblebee people would put fucking bones in there.
I am really hungry. I wish I could eat more.
Why can't you eat more? You grossed out by it?
It's very heavy.
Oh, is that the answer?
Do you make this for your gal?
Yeah, she didn't like it.
No. Wait. You made this for her?
Yeah, she's helping.
You said, let me cook tonight and made this?
Yeah. She ate it to be polite, but she didn't.
For a woman you love? For a woman you love?
What did she do? How are the bites, Lou? Was she like, oh, this is so good, Poppy?
I don't want seconds.
She said she didn't want seconds?
Nope.
Did she finish her first, though?
I don't know. Maybe she put it in a napkin. I'm not sure.
Oh, man.
Did she ever cook for you?
Yeah, she cooked for me last week. It was great.
Lou, what did she make?
You know who would absolutely love this? Myrtle.
Yeah.
Oh, my God, for sure.
Dawkins would. Scoop this up.
Yeah. Oh, now I can't get it out of my mind that it resembles wet food.
Come on,
I can't see it now. Can't unsee it.
To answer your question, she cooked me lovely salmon. She's very much like Jacob.
And then you throw 2 cans of tuna into some shells for her?
I barely finished that fucking salmon because it was too healthy.
Lou, can I tell you? So pleasantly surprised with shells. I'm a shell boy.
Yes.
I love it.
Yes.
I love a good shell. This was...
A lot of shells are what you're decorating them with.
You said
Fucking Canada Dry makes the world go round, dude.
I know.
That cures whatever ails you.
Yeah, dude.
That'll take down the harshest Robitussin shot.
I bust this in from Jersey. Have it with me on tuna casserole all day.
I'm gonna grab myself some seconds. You guys continue on.
There's no way you're getting more.
Yeah, dude. Yeah, we're just having a plate.
Loves it.
You're gonna choose to fill up on this today.
Love it.
What about dinner later?
No dinner.
He can drink for a week with this in his stomach.
Oh, for that is absolutely for sure.
That's how it gets.
Christine, come get some.
With his padding?
Yeah.
He calls it booze padding.
Don't eat one little fork.
Take a bite.
Christine, show if Jacob eats a bite, show him your titty. Damn, you don't want to see Christine's titties that bad, Jacob? That's fucked up. I didn't mean to put you in that position, Christine.
Lou, what kind of seasoning are you tossing this bad boy?
Just a little oregano, salt and pepper, some sea salt. Maybe you're familiar with, Jacob?
Oregano is not necessary at all.
No.
Nope.
You know what, though? I like you taking risks.
There's genuinely no need for that. If you told me celery salt would have made more sense.
Oregano goes on everything, and I don't want it to be bland.
Oregano doesn't go on everything.
That's not true.
It's a very specific, harsh flavor.
Black Lou has his hand over his forehead.
You put in everything. Cereal, French toast.
Black Lou, is this turning out the way you thought it was going to?
100%.
There's something bubbling in me.
I thought Jacob would at least take a little bit, though. Come on, Jacob.
Why did you think that?
He's your future roommate. He's extending, you know, some love, man.
I thought I was very clear.
Just take a bite, Jacob.
Come on.
No.
Jacob, please.
No.
It's healthy. I ate like 10 bites.
No.
I took down half a plate.
I was a big boy.
Yeah, I'm going to clean my plate.
How about if I airplane it into your mouth?
Oh, my God. What if there's a special
Jacob,
flight?
Jacob, they're filming
that
today.
That doesn't work on me anymore, Jay.
Jacob. Drago, we're filming, and you're a producer, dude. You're not going to be to see me airplane.
Whatever. Yeah, don't let
Lou food in your mouth.
Let it land.
There's an airplane going by.
To quote DJ Lou, I do audio guy, not video.
Yeah, but we're doing video, though.
Right on.
It's part of the deal, man. It's in the deal memo. Lou's dancing and eating it. He's in such a good mood right now. He's in a happy place.
My favorite DJ Lou line ever. I do audio guy, not spelling.
Do audio guy.
You know what, Lou? I'm enjoying it.
I knew you were going to like this.
Jacob.
I think it's a very nice dish.
For the show,
one bite?
Yo, no. Trish can
fucking cook. For the show, no. I'm not doing
it. I threw up after I drank.
You might just like me. I'm not doing this. I put my foot down here.
I drank fucking buffalo wing soda and threw up into a trash can.
Man, that was awesome.
You're a big Jay Oakerson. Big comedian.
Big rock star. Big rock star comedian.
I grew up having my dad cook for me, and this really is just such a dad dish.
You know what it is? My mom was a good cook, so it was like this was almost like a sexy treat.
Can I ask you a question, though? Was she?
Yeah, she is.
She is?
Yeah, I've had like Katie ate and was like, that was phenomenal.
Oh, okay.
She's like, your mom's a phenomenal cook.
Oh, okay.
No, even like my family.
That's such a fucking skill. They bend
the
knee.
Well, no, here's the thing. I would always, like,
she makes appetizers. Fun appetizers.
Oh, yeah, she has like a business.
My mom was not a good, she cooked.
My grandmother cooks, she's not that good.
Yeah, but she always cooked my grandmother, but she never made anything. It was season it yourself.
Yes.
This is fish.
Trish, like, Trish puts
and now it, you put salt in whatever you put on it.
No, Trish throws it down. Like puts it. She's a very good cook.
Yeah,
yeah. I grew up lucky with a mom that could.
Well, my grandma,
and also she'd get.
Well, my grandma could throw down was the Jewish food on the holidays, like the brisket.
Yeah,
best.
See,
ever.
My mom would miss on certain stuff. My mom would like try some stuff and be off, but I bet she was like 90%. 90% amazing, and then sometimes you're like, all right, that wasn't the best.
My mother is a horrific cook.
Really?
Yeah. But happy to say, when we went to my sister's, we had to make the correction, remember? We went to my sister's for Thanksgiving. Good food, man.
Great.
They made really good food.
Yeah, Haley likes to cook, so.
It did not pass down.
Trish is a risk taker, so she'll try stuff. That's usually where she misses.
Well, the culinary arts are a playground there.
But she's, you know.
And Trish is on that slot.
I would love to see Jacob and Trish in the kitchen together. I think they would, that'd be a great dish.
Is anybody else sweating?
No.
Oh, maybe it's the casserole.
Why are you getting in your head about it?
No. Jacob, it's honestly not that bad, but I need to see you have a forkful.
I'm not a snob about it. Like, I just didn't. It's not what I've ever eaten. I can't eat it.
It's a forkful.
What do you mean?
Yeah.
It's all the things happening. Made of this world.
You've never had cream of mushroom soup or tuna?
That's crazy.
You eat tuna all the time.
I eat tuna all the time, but not together.
Well, let me tell you.
What do you act like?
It's
you
a match
eat
made
cream
in
of mushroom soup and tuna together regularly.
I just did.
Yeah, just now we did.
No, no, regular. You act like you do this once
no,
a week.
No, I'm saying you've never had either of those ingredients. You said it's stuff that I've never.
Yeah, you're
eaten
making it sound like you've never touched your lips these situations. Peas,
well, cream
I'm sure.
Of I don't like cream anyway.
How do you keep your casseroles from drying out?
Yeah.
I've never made a casserole.
Gloop, dude. How do your casserole hold the gloop?
What do you use for gloop?
What's your go-to gloop?
What's your gloop then, man?
It's called glop, guy. Glop.
Sorry, what's your glop?
What's your glop? I mean, you just throw this thing if you know how to do that. It's fucking wasabi peas.
Jay, I go, what's the glop in this?
What are you using for glop? Because I'm getting hints of cream of broccoli in there, maybe.
Is that Campbell's cup of glop?
Jacob, look at me right now.
I have a carb limit.
Jacob, look at this real quick. Look at how much is on this plate.
Jacob.
Let me say this before you start saying no.
Look how much is on my plate.
Look at me.
You ate the whole thing, Dan.
I didn't. Jacob.
You have such a tummy ache.
Am I?
Jacob, I didn't want this when it was warm. It's now chilly. And
I'm going to stop you right now. It's not happening.
I'll finish this plate if you take one bite.
One bite.
I'm telling you, not an MP. Christine knows what my problem is with taste and texture once I get something in my head. If I bite into a funny piece of chicken, dinner's done. I'm done. It's that kind of weird thing.
And you know me. I'm the mountain goat.
This is telling me I'm going right back in for that gristly piece. And I'll do it if you take one bite. This might make me have a funnier reaction than you have.
I don't want to waste your time. I don't want it. It's not happening.
Damn. Is it the ingredients?
Yeah.
Do you think it's the preparation that you don't agree with? What is it?
Jacob?
I don't eat. I wouldn't eat. Oh, God. You're pulling stuff out.
Oh, God. So you don't like cream of mushroom?
I don't like the ingredients. Yeah. So no, I don't like.
Canned tuna you're okay with?
Yeah, but I've never combined it. I never liked like tuna.
Peas
with,
you like, though, right?
Tuna with any cheese.
Peas you like. Oh, what are you?
Not really.
Oh, you're bitching over the 10 Kraft singles that top the stick. That's the line you're drawing.
You're talking about the cholesterol force field.
You're talking about that plastic cheese that's running all through this thing? Dude. You got to get over that, dude.
Just learn it.
You're out making me out to be a snob, but I mean,
listen,
I don't
Jacob,
want it.
We're
you're,
all...
a bit, you're being a bit of a snob by not
no,
having
I'm
a bite.
Not.
A bite.
No, I don't want, it doesn't appeal to me.
Science,
I'm sorry.
That's
not
funny.
Even...
It doesn't appeal to me either.
Appeals to me, though.
I mean, wine in a can doesn't appeal to me, but it was fucking great.
Oh, he did that for your family's company.
Yeah.
Already sold a bunch, by the way. See people posting in the camper's Facebook thing.
Then begged me for a can in the morning.
And you didn't give it to him.
And you wouldn't give it to him.
And
now
you
can't
even give him
one bite of a tuna casserole.
You know why? Because he's getting sent a case.
Yeah.
I just made Lou's day instantly.
Side note, campers say you don't deliver to Connecticut, and that's a big problem.
There's about... only 32 states you're legally allowed to mail to. The others,
but some
in
places,
stores,
by the way, got their deliveries already. I saw a thing when people posting they got them shut up, and we talked about it on Monday.
They're already
I
going through a divorce.
I really do appreciate.
He goes CPS. It was I saw in the background was a picture of CPS taking their kids away.
So it looks like they got it.
So it's working.
Looks like they got the rosé.
He was four cans in the hand, going like two bottles of wine.
A local officer called it worse than PCP.
Enjoy it, but it does hit you.
Dude, Jacob, just take a fork. I know you don't want to. I don't want to do it. I don't want to pay taxes, but I do.
He's right.
I do.
He does.
I fucking do, dude.
I've seen it.
Me too.
Cool.
All right.
Take a bite. I just ate a plate.
I don't like cream of anything. I don't like
cream. You want to see your friend hurting?
Not even cream.
I'm going to keep eating this until you do it.
Do it, dude.
Be my friend.
We'll eat
stop
that whole
him.
Tray then.
Stop him.
So cold.
I forgot about your texture problem no, Jay. Yeah.
Jason,
the cheese is congealing again.
It's coagulated.
You need it fast
it's
enough.
Congealing in the shells. I know what I'm doing.
Thank God your co-host is a Roomba. You get me another can of dry, that plate will be gone. You get me another cold can of dry, I'll walk through that thing.
Oh, my God. If we were in the gay studio still, we'd be fucked right now. Yeah. They'd be furious. Smells like pussy in here.
What did they do? Just have a bunch of lesbian sex?
Yeah, smells like cheesy pussy in this place. Kraft cheesy pussy.
Read the Andy diary entry. I don't do cheesy pussy anymore.
Oh, my God.
I broke my headphones.
Jacob.
Dude, Jacob, come on. No. One bite.
A bite.
I don't want it.
I know you don't want it. I don't think you want it. We're not under the guise that you want
just
it.
Just got a big piece of oregano.
You're welcome.
Such a weird, change such your a mind
weird,
now?
That's such a weird spice to have that. I haven't changed my mind.
No,
try
on the
it.
Flavor profile. Was he right? Oregano does go.
I said, I'm the one who pointed out there's no need for oregano in this to begin with.
Yeah, quit trying to change the subject.
I am trying to change the subject.
Jacob, I'm not arguing with you.
I know
this is
we're
a travesty
not
of food.
I can't do it.
Buddy.
There's nothing.
You can do one bite. You can do one bite.
Dan's already going to shit blood for the bit. You see how much that he took down?
I've done a lot.
I'll do it.
I can't do this.
You can't do this? This is your line?
Yeah.
But you'll do the odd thruple house as long as you don't have to eat his cooking.
Nice red herring.
I didn't say that. I don't want to.
It's two strikes, Jacob.
I'm softening on that because I do. The producer in me is winning.
A lot of oregano.
The oregano is so weird.
Yeah, I keep getting like pieces of oregano on my pulling out of my teeth, and I'm like, "What's oregano like to begin
Italian
with?"
Italian flavor in Kraft American.
What's the matter, you? Hey, what do you gotta do? Hey, oregano and everything. What's your mama gonna say?
This dish is. It got me there.
Yep.
Do you only know salt, pepper, and oregano?
It's very Mediterranean. With
do you
oregano
only know, do you only know the options tuna offered you at a sandwich place?
Lou, I love. I felt like I was in Corsica. I just felt like I was in the Mediterranean with the tuna and the oregano.
Under the Tuscan sun, as I
the
sit.
The cheese melted like a sunset in Tuscany.
I hopped on my basket bike with a big old loaf of bread and the thing in the front.
I go to different stands and try their products.
I try some of the Parmesan, some of the Ragout.
Vincenzo Kraft always had the best singles.
Some of the Romano. Vincenzo Craftini. The Craftini family. Right next to the Velveetas.
The secret is the tunas in the water.
We had to sit still and take it.
You haven't had
the Italians. It was real greaseball shit.
You haven't had tuna casserole till you had the tuna pulled right out of the channel.
I'm telling you,
boy.
You have it. You bring it with you on a bus from New Jersey.
Stugatz.
Maron. I love it.
You clean that fish. You take it home. Fresh fish. And then with 10 magical slices of Craftini cheese.
One bite, Jacob.
And you go, is this cheese? He goes, does this cheese have a wrapper on it still? He goes, no, it just takes the shape of the wrapper.
It goes into the wrapper.
You drink it up, bad boy.
Jacob.
What if I told you you could bring back Gilbert Gottfried?
It means so much to you.
It means so much to me.
Because everybody in the room had a bite.
It's a sign. It's a sign of solidarity.
It's a blood oath. It's a tuna oath.
I can't.
Would you do this for Jamie Foxx? Shout out, Foxhole.
Jamie wouldn't ask me to do this.
Yeah, okay, see,
he make you go to a weird sex party.
Can we give you
touché?
Can we give you alternatives? Can we say you eat a forkful of this, or you have to eat an entire delicious cake on air?
Whole cake?
Oh, no, I
whole cake.
A whole cake.
Full cake.
A whole delicious cake.
75
your
cheat
pick,
days.
Your whole. I mean, you pick the whole cake. You pick the cake. You can make
no,
the cake.
No, I don't. I can't. He got me. I mean, please, let's move on. This is.
It's what we call a squeeze. You know what, Jacob?
It's gray.
Black Lou, you would have tried if you were here at least, right?
Yep.
Black
Absolutely.
Lou.
Absolutely. I trust Lou and his cooking.
Yeah.
Well, let me say,
I believe Lou put his heart into
it. But he did try. Huh?
Yeah, I believe he put his heart into it.
For sure.
I'm over here part of the Clean Plate Club, so anybody needs me, I'll be over in Good Boy Corner.
I'll tell you something. This is something my mom would have thrown together for a Cub Scout potluck.
Well, Terry, Lou, and all those other people that are just grabbing at air when they're cooking, God bless you.
If I call my mom and I go, Mom, what do I do? I have tuna, shells, Kraft singles, and peas, and a couple of cream of soups.
Get 10 Kraft singles.
She goes, I'll make a fucking casserole.
Yeah.
What are you, an idiot?
You said it, honey.
Canned peas?
Thank you, Mama. Not my mom.
Or frozen peas.
Everything's canned in this ingredient.
Shut up, dude. Canned peas?
Dad, you were on the ship of life.
No, I ripped them from their stupid leaves. No, they're in a fucking can.
They're just sitting in wet.
Frozen peas?
Huh? Yeah, dude, that's what the tuna was sitting in.
You bought a can of, it was a can of peas.
This whole meal was bought at a Welsh Farms.
Yes.
What does that mean? That sounds amazing.
I think it's a gas station.
That means it's a, yeah.
It's a gas station.
It's not what you think, Jay.
That's crazy.
As he said that, the wind got sucked out of my sails for enjoying this. He goes, bought all this at a Welsh Farms. And you go, Isn't that a gas station?
Gas station ingredients.
It can be a gas station, but there was none connected to this particular one. Okay.
Nuh-uh. Yeah, sometimes it's a gas station.
Not giving me faith in the
you
tuna.
You got meal ingredients from like a Wawa type place.
Wells Farms is what Wawa, they're connected
Wolves
somehow.
To me one day.
They just don't have a stupid geese on the front, but they're very similar.
It's a goose. It's not a geese.
You're a goose.
Jay, I think it's JV Wawa.
Hey, Jay.
Yeah?
Nom, 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 nom.
You could be a real son of a bitch, Jacob.
Jacob, I'm
one
better.
One bite.
One bite, dude. I'm stronger for it. I mean, yeah, it's tough that it's from a Welsh farm.
Right. He's bummed.
I now, might. That's the thing.
Dan's, for some reason, whatever has been said since Dan finished that plate has personified in what Dan thinks is in his stomach right now, where he's like, this is dancing around, and it's probably not good ingredients, huh?
Yeah, it is. It's like, oh, C's getting angry.
Gas station peas? I don't know how I feel about that.
I'm giving you till 6:30.
I feel like you just raw dogged me and then told me you had herpes.
I feel like Campbell's soup might be one of the worst things you could possibly eat.
Shush, don't you? Please, shush.
Just condensed salt.
I am growing more and more nervous by the minute.
Lou, why?
But
give me the genuine story behind the oregano.
I don't think he has a lot of spices.
I just use it in everything. Absolutely everything.
Mac and cheese.
Of course.
That's insane.
Eggs.
Why? Why in mac and cheese?
Eggs.
You steak. Put just oregano in eggs.
Oregano
just
eggs?
Nilly.
Lou's famous oregano eggs. Wakey, wakey. Oh. Eggs in oregano bakey.
Oh, looks like it's the old whiskey recipe of French toast with oregano.
Oh, you haven't lived until you've had my banana oregano pancakes.
It's such a harmless spice. I really don't think it's a problem.
Harmless? It's the only flavor still in my mouth, and there was tuna involved.
I had fresh ground pepper. Did you taste that?
Fresh ground?
Yeah.
From a mill. Or is it in a bottle?
Did it say fresh ground pepper in a bottle?
From a mill?
Or what did you go like this? You didn't go like that? Then it's not fresh ground pepper, dude.
It's a lie.
It's fresh because I keep the cap Krieger on top and it doesn't get bad.
Fresh as hell.
It's still, you mean that we haven't reached the expiration date on this pepper? Okay.
I never let it go sour.
Damn, dude. Can I ask you a question?
Sure.
This pepper, this fresh ground pepper, did you purchase pepper? Or is this a pepper where it's like shows like pictures of like black onions and stuff on one, and then there's white onions on the salt?
No.
Like you took it from a Pizza Hut?
No, I got it from the real supermarket, not from the Welsh Farms.
And you chose to go with a container of fresh ground pepper versus a pepper mill sitting right next to it?
I'm not going to grind it.
I mean, it's not really, okay.
What? You're going to have to twist? It's crazy.
It's just a twist. You just put a little extra zip.
I'll just shake it out.
Listen, I grew up with the pepper thing he has for sure.
We all do.
That's a small, like it's sort of a rectangle, short rectangle, and it's got three openings. One to pour it onto a spoon, one for like a little bit thicker, and one a little bit smaller of a shaker.
We had a one that turned.
Okay, fancy ass. We all didn't grow up in the fucking awesome town of Colorado.
Well,
Aurora,
we kept
Colorado.
It, we kept it in the East Wing.
West yes, Wing. We only did it for parties.
Yes.
It's but I grew up with all that shit too, but eventually, you know, you meet other adults, and you become 40-something, and they go, hey, man. Pepper mill's right there.
Hey,
pepper mill's is better pepper. Why not grab it? I don't know why I get Himalayan pink sea salt, but it's good.
They start giving you hints like Crate and Barrel gift cards.
Yeah.
Why don't you go pick out some pepper shaker?
Yeah, what would you get if you got a Crate and Barrel gift card, dude? Do they got a buffet?
Do they sell tuna?
I wouldn't go in there.
You wouldn't even walk in there.
Why?
Can I tell you something? I appreciate your commitment to like, fuck it. It's a good commitment to the bit.
I got the flavor I wanted. This is how I wanted to come out. I'm very happy with it.
I like Lou's attitude. You're going to love this. Who cares if the couch cushions are from the same couch? You're going to love that. Jacob, this house is going to be so awesome. You're going to be eating tuna casserole, begging to come home.
You're
going to go mad. You're going to have circles in your eyes just eating tuna casserole in a fucking camera going like, get me out of here. Yeah. I'm losing it.
I mean, you keep acting this way, you're never going to get my meatloaf.
Bring your meatloaf.
Bring it.
Bring your meatloaf.
What's the ingredients
in 2 weeks?
In that?
Not oregano, I'll tell you that.
It's a steak with
breadcrumbs.
I want
to hear the ingredients.
Can I tell you something? There was going to be oregano until this very moment in that meatloaf for sure.
It's a given.
Change anything, Lou. I want your oregano meatloaf.
How do you make your meatloaf?
100% ground chuck, not steak. like a pound of that, two eggs,
okay,
breadcrumbs, still got them from the last casserole, put them in there, salt, pepper.
It's going to take...
You do any, like, bell onions? You do regular onions?
Onions, thank you. Onions, that's
bell
it.
Bell peppers?
That's it. And then you just mush it in there with love.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Wash your hands first.
You put a little glaze on the top there at all? Or?
Sometimes you can put ketchup as a glaze, but I'm against it.
I'm not.
I love a ketchup
glaze. Well, you don't like texture, so I would not do that to you.
I'll use some sort of like a maple ketchup-y glaze. It's pretty fantastic.
Oh, yeah? Can I get it in the regular bottle, or do you have some fancy bullshit I don't know about?
No, Lou, I'm sorry. You can get it at your gas station grocery store where you do all your fucking fine food shopping.
You can get it at your Welsh's Farms. Hey, Jacob.
Hey, babe. Surprise, I just got a cucumber from the gas station.
So we're good to go.
Produce is in.
Chop it up. Put it in the water. We're living the high life. Could you take a shot at this dish? Do you think
the meatloaf?
No.
He actually didn't list anything. I'd probably try that.
Can you do the Jacob take on a tuna casserole and bring it in?
I don't know what. I never made a casserole before.
Well,
I can try.
Oh, if you listen
in
the distance, that's Nikki Dinky's pussy drying up.
Yeah.
So
come on, dude.
I can try.
Way to take
sure.
a challenge,
bro. Why don't you try and see if you can.
Because some Lou's already halfway dunking dick already just because he's forgiven the attempt. That turns her on.
I love Nikki Dinky.
Oregano?
All my life, do more oregano. I haven't bit this thing for 45 minutes.
It's harmless.
It is harmless.
Go eat some pizza later. You don't need spices.
What?
That sounds like an old New Jersey slang. Like that's like an insult. Go eat pizza later. You don't need the spices.
Sometimes oregano. I put oregano. Sometimes I put oregano on pizza. Sometimes I do because I'm at a pizza place. I'm getting a slice,
yeah.
And I'm like, throw all the fucking fixings on. Every time I regret oregano.
Well, guess what?
It's unnecessary.
What if I said I had a dish for you that was tuna, 10 Kraft slices, and a necessary amount.
And just a dash,
yeah.
A little dash part two, and a clump.
It's going to be funny when I go home and Katie's like, what do you want for dinner? And I'm like, I'm not really that hungry. She's like, why?
You should have filmed yourself making it.
Ah, oh, I would have loved that.
You should have really filmed yourself making it. And I would have just seen the inordinate amount of oregano you put in this thing.
How much oregano did you put in it?
Scoop.
I put oregano in the actual tuna in the beginning while the shells were boiling.
What? Guys, dude, that's, he
you gotta spice up the tuna.
That's insane.
Have you ever made a casserole, Jay?
That is a good question. Have you ever made a casserole?
We're waiting.
You mix the oregano with the tuna.
Yeah, that's
dude,
that's
I love
insane.
Lou, look at me. I love that you inceptioned the casserole.
Oregano tuna.
You and oregano.
First you made oregano tuna.
Yes.
So it's actually oregano tuna casserole.
Yes.
That's a good name for it. I think that really gives it some pizzazz.
Oregano.
Oregano? Oregalotto.
Yeah. Well, Jacob's already picked up a fork and he's walking over to take a bite. Oregano, says Adam B.
Dude.
Oh, buddy.
Oregano. In your mac and cheese?
Could I put parsley? Would that have made it better for
you? It makes no sense also. Parsley has no place in this.
Parsley?
Parsley?
It was parsley in this?
Are you just saying the first like things you ever heard from like what you think vegetables are?
Wait, am I not saying that right? Parsley? What's the green thing?
No. Parsley is what you're talking about, but it's a garnish, dude.
Garnish.
Are you thinking of cilantro?
No, I don't. I don't even know what that
cilantro
is.
Cilantro would have not... Black Lou, don't say crazy things. Don't give him crazy ideas.
Lou's like, that's the crossover I've been waiting for.
Cilantro.
What happens when the Southwest meets the Northeast?
What kind of mac and cheese do you make when you make mac and cheese?
Kraft.
Yeah.
That's what I'm saying. So you make that mac, and then you add
Kraft mac and cheese is perfect with just Kraft mac and cheese.
I love a little black pepper on it.
No.
I'll put a little black pepper on it.
Whatever.
That's not crazy.
A little pepper on
it. I would never put salt. I put ketchup on it when I was a child.
I love it with hot sauce.
All of that makes more sense than oregano and anything you've put oregano in so far.
But you put oregano on Kraft mac and cheese?
He puts oregano on bagels, dude. He said everything.
Cereal? Yeah.
Do you think oregano is one of the flavors on everything bagels?
Yeah.
I just like it. And it's not on everything bagels, but it is in my house.
You like it.
I like
He's oregano. A sucker for an oregano. A nice oregano.
Heard that.
It's not like I love garlic. That would be worse. I'd smell.
Oregano Lou.
Sure, that would be brutal. But I'm surprised. I didn't realize what a major part oregano played in your life.
There was a little garlic in there, too. Did you taste it?
That makes sense. That makes sense on why this entire time I've known Lou he's always been like, I'm an OG. And I always was like, what? He's like, oregano gangster. You never asked what the O meant. It was there the whole time.
I'm going to say in some of these recipes you're throwing out there, try them sans oregano. See what you come up with.
Yeah, do them naked. Do like a naked tuna casserole. That's what you could call
it. You see Gordon Ramsay's constantly tasting as he's cooking.
I did that.
And you said not enough oregano.
It was too bland, and I added pepper and a little bit more.
Just grabbing handfuls of oregano. Just boosh.
Come on, baby. Yeah, I'm the papa. I go, oh, there she is.
Oh, I feel like the tuna and the oregano are finally wrestling. Still not. Could you do your take on this?
I always thought oregano was for looks on garlic bread. It was for pure looks on garlic bread, more or less.
I don't like the whole idea of a casserole. I don't like the main...
What would be your take on a casserole? Walk us through this.
Let's say...
I wouldn't do it because what do you have to have in a casserole?
It's everything together, dude.
Jacob.
It's the orgy of food.
No money.
Yeah, it's just a bunch of shit slapped together.
Yeah, dude, he picked up the ingredients getting a pack of smokes. You realize that?
Yeah. Yes. He walked in the store and said, pack of Marlboro Lights,
Ramon?
And then circled around the one aisle of groceries.
And then he went, Ramon, where's the tuna? And he went, we have cat tuna for the bodega cat.
He goes, a fresh batch? I'm just fucking with you. Throw it on there. You would have to have a can of peas. You do have a can of peas. Over there by what? The snow? The icer?
Look, 30 whole 30 casseroles.
Jacob.
Come on, Jacob.
Casserole time.
Casserole.
I bet Nikki Dinky would throw out a casserole.
I bet you guys could collab on a casserole.
I bet she makes awesome casseroles that you can
enjoy. In fact, you know what? Call up the Dinks. Get Dinks on the phone.
Get Dinks on the horn. Where's the Dinks hotline?
Where's the Nikki Dinky hotline?
I want a cooking show with Lou and her so bad. Just watch it.
Weird thing to say.
I would love to see Nikki Dinky's take on Lewitsky's famous oregano tuna casserole.
Yeah,
oregano tuna casserole.
I was to God.
You have to double down on the oregano.
You guys can push on my shoulders until I suck my own dick if she says that oregano makes sense in this.
No, I'm saying I want to see her take on it. There's absolutely no way she'll say it makes sense.
Yeah, you don't have to suck your dick.
Thank you. I'll try still, though, if you guys want to push on my shoulders.
I'm saying,
I've always wondered if I could do it if people push on my shoulders.
All I'm saying is you guys got the weight.
I was just trying to get to that.
I was just saying I could probably do it if you guys helped.
Spaghetti pizza casserole.
Look at that.
Spaghetti squash, though. Jacob, spaghetti squash. I know it looks like... Wait, go back up to that first one. It looks like the wall etchings in the alien ship. It's like baby aliens, shrimp, people and skeletons everywhere. Go down.
I don't think you could eat that kind of textures.
Well, this one's got pepperoni in it. No, Jacob, you're out still.
Jacob, are you completely out on the idea of casseroles? What's wrong with casseroles, dude?
Have you never had a green bean casserole?
I had a casserole.
Chicken and broccoli. It's paleo and Whole30.
I had a casserole 20 minutes ago. As I was licking that plate.
He's going to have it again later.
Before then.
What's your problem, Jacob?
I don't know. I live two in the moment. I think turkey tetrazzini is technically a casserole, isn't it?
Chicken tetrazzini?
Turkey tetrazzini. Get your head out of your ass.
Now, chicken tetrazzini is a thing as normally your mom makes turkey tetrazzini.
Goddamn right.
And you just started spreading that to the world like that's the right tetrazzini.
Is that what we're finding out?
Turkey tetrazzini, I've only heard come out of your mouth in my life.
Shit, it's chicken?
Yeah.
Damn. Trish.
But, no.
Fooled me with your sleepy meats.
She was good. She was trying to put you out.
She's trying to get some fucking time to herself to watch an episode of Murphy Brown. Oh, this big kid falling.
Hey, I made you a turkey milkshake. I don't know why I made her DJ Lou.
I love it.
I know why. That's your only voice.
Damn, dude.
I had several bites.
Turns out Lou had some spice in that tetrazzini.
Oh, sorry.
Tetrazzini? I don't know.
Sticking up for your main man, oregano.
Yeah, dude, what's up? Does big oregano have you in their pocket? Is this all propaganda from big oregano?
The only healthy thing I eat, if it is even healthy.
It's so not healthy.
Oregano, how can it be bad?
Oh, that one ingredient.
Is it bad?
No, oregano's not bad.
I don't know what it is.
I thought he meant the whole dish.
No.
Casserole, dude.
Casserole life, dude.
Oh, right there.
Fuck salt life. Live that casserole life.